Hey guys, how's it going? December 4th. It is 4:30 p.m. in the East, and we are back live. Did I do that right? Yeah, looks like I did it right. Okay. If not, oh well. I don't know. So yeah, it's 4:30 in the East, and wow, that was a fun weekend I had. As you can see, weekends things die off for me as far as Run8 goes because my son is the main focus for me. But I've been trying to get him, he's into trains. Make no mistake about it, he's into trains. Although we haven't been doing too much lately, we'll go to Fostoria. We've been down to Folkston, Georgia before when he was younger. We're heading out, we are heading out west next July. To go across Canada again. It'll be the first time we've done it since 5 years ago when he was very young. He's 8 now, so this one, hopefully he remembers parts of it, which is really strange considering he was not quite 4 yet. So this will be just before his 9th birthday actually. We'll be heading out there, going to British Columbia to see my biological mom family, or my biological mom and half brothers, I should say. But that was the last time we went 5 years ago, was the trip we took out there. I'm not sure if that was the first time she met my son or not, but we go out there. I tend to go out west anyways every 5 years. That was the first time I actually went to see her. I've only known her for 10 years. So I'm in my mid-40s now, so yeah, about 10 years we've known each other. It's hard to believe it's been 10 years. But man. But yeah, it's great. Yeah, 'cause my mom was still alive. And yeah, she wasn't too she seemed to be a little concerned about my biological mom, but my mom is still my mom, not and I refer to her by her name, Lou. She's just Lou to me. Of course, she's very important to me because she is my biological mom. She's my biological grandmother to my son. Of course, he has his own grandmother as well, but on the other side. But you know, there's very important, but to have the bonds there. But as far as everything else, and it's interesting because I know I'm going off on totally something that has nothing to do with Run8, but I'll link that in here just to get. I'll go to the main menu here and I'll show you. And this is, let me link this to Run8, and then I'll tell you a story about all of this, what this means. I'm gonna go into the Southeast US actually. There's three regions, of course, with Run8. You've got the Southwest, which is your busy main focus of California, which of course the main developers are all centered in that area and do quite a bit on. You've got so I mean it is really set up well. It's set up with the most amount of resources. When you come to the Southeast, now you've got two guys who do their best. I believe they both work. I know Jason drives truck, so he's not always around, although he does a lot because he I believe he runs team with his wife truck across country in the States. So that's all. There's a lot less resources into this, but it's a very beautiful route as well. And he's got major updates coming up, so it's well done. I mean, he just recently released a second update after version 2 came out that actually added some AI traffic into the NS Diamond. Now I kind of explored it a little bit, and there's I actually it sounds as if he might be adding another one in the Florida East Coast. I'm not too sure, but hint hint, I'd love to see it. At least we would, my son and I. But I'll get to that in a minute. Why that's important with my son and I. It's very interesting because I'm not very active when it comes to the Florida server. At least I'm not at the moment. Hopefully that will change. Selkirk, this is probably the most beautiful route out of all three. And I don't mean that with any disrespect to the other two. Southwest, I mean, you're basically desert, and I mean it's huge, and the network is huge, and the resources that are into it, and the operations potential, and the amount of traffic is just huge. You got the transcontinental in there. With the Southeast, you're basically, you're kind of into a. When you go into A-line, if for those of you not familiar with recent, you got up to Georgia, which is Folkestone. Now, mind you, this route is expanding towards Waycross, and there is a huge hump in there, probably the biggest. I don't know how well that's going to run, even with version 2 and the bigger memory. It'll be interesting to see. I'm curious. I certainly have some major curiosity when it comes to that. But as far as running a lot of main lines, and this is the reason why I stuck with California, because Tom and I were actually, Tom was going to take over California, and I was going to take on Florida when it first came out. It was, I don't know what the banging, somebody's hammering or something. I thought somebody was knocking on my door. But we have Selkirk and, Selkirk and A-Line were coming out at around the same time, give or take. And what had happened was, I was going to take this, and then I realized how much I was going to miss the hump. And I realized Selkirk, I wasn't too, I just didn't know enough about, and I didn't want to get into it. And A-Line came out first, I believe. Yeah, Selkirk was the third one. But I saw a lot of pictures of it, and I mean, you look at some of this stuff. I mean, this I actually ran a train the other day, going through this. There's some issues. There's definitely some issues with this route, as far as operations. There's some signals that don't clear up by Albany for some reason. The dispatch board, the lights don't match in some places. It's really weird. And probably as I've griped, and I'll do it again, I don't know how many times I've said it, and yeah, I'm sure they're sick of hearing me say this if it gets it out there, but there's not enough spawn points. Especially not a, come on, like, add Mohawk. You got a whole route. I mean, add some spawn points. And I know these guys were busy trying to beta test and get this stuff out. So a lot of what I found was when I first opened up California when version 2 came and I did the busy Barstow, I found there was two systems. There was the system that was set up for the spawns, and then there was the tags that were kind of set up in the middle or something. It was almost like a beta. Bunch of cars that were sitting around, and if you've seen Busy Barstool, you'll see that when you know that it is coming from AI spawns, or it's coming from AI generated spawns, you will see the train name in the tag. If you don't see that, then they are before that there were some manual tags, either that or some people were just manually tagging stuff for some strange reason. I prefer to bring everything into the world that is coming out of a spawn, theoretically. Either that, or you're loading in spawns out of RTS or whatever other contraption you want to do. But, and I appreciate the fact that they're using the X. Apparently, they're using the XMLs because of RTS. That's what I heard. And I'm pretty honored to hear that. Unfortunately, I'm not too sure. I was supposed to meet with Mike Wierowski tonight. I hope I pronounce his name right. I've never asked him that. Wierowski is his last name. He just goes by Ski, because there's so many Mikes. There's Mike who the server. There's Mike who's a programmer, fairly new this year within the California community, and he did some great stuff for version 1 of RTS, right towards just before version 2 came out, and man, was he making things a lot simpler. And I know they're looking for support. But anyways, I'm rambling on because I'm getting off topic. But anyways, this route here is the, look at this. This is the most beautiful route in Run8, bar none. No disrespect to, and I mean, there's some beautiful scenery in Southeast, but this is absolutely gorgeous. And it's just, it's a fun route to run, and it's a shame that the operations aren't set up. I mean, yes, there's yards, yes, there's an operating hump in Selkirk. It's got a lot going for it. It's just, unfortunately, it's not set up for the AI system. And I don't like that. And had that been done, I guarantee, or I don't guarantee you, but I'm can pretty much, considering that Smiley's computer just went down, I would probably set up a server again, and I would say, you know, I'm gonna do it. But because Mohawk's not included, I'm not doing it. At least not yet. Maybe in the new year, maybe I'll reconsider. Hopefully there's some updates. Add some spawn points. I mean, it's not like it can't be that much to add a spawn point. But anyways, that's just my griping. So, but when it comes to routes, when you want to do single player, there's, and I was getting to this anyways, the thing about this route is, as it is right now at least, the major traffic actually goes down the Callahan sub. So it goes through Folkestone either by Race Pond or, yeah, generally by Race Pond if it's the manifest, and some of the intermodals also go into Jacksonville intermodal. But anything south of Jacksonville is generally just a little bit of manifest, a couple unit trains. There's a lot of, or a few unit trains, actually quite a few unit trains. I shouldn't say quite a few, but a fair amount. But the traffic level south of Jacksonville is not that busy, at least when it was modeled. Of course, now they have the SunRail project, which is totally different, but this is not in this era, thankfully, because I didn't want to model SunRail, forget that. We don't have the models, and I don't want to model something. I'd rather model back in its, you know, modern yet not too old configuration. And so the A-line's really good for if you are running single player and you want to run a part of an operating system and you want to have the AI elements. This is actually set up really well. Even if you say for example, and this is, there's some extra spawn points in here. I wish there was a Florida East Coast one, but that's okay. That's just a minor thing. It's just Florida East Coast. It's no big deal. He's got NS in there. But what I found today when I went into this is I found that there was a spawn point for, well, there's a couple of them. There's spawns for both north and south out of the Jacksonville ramps. Because I went into his save file and I noticed that Jacksonville, or sorry, the ramps were empty, but the yards had cars in them, and Taft had stuff. Unfortunately, didn't have any freight, and it picks one out of six freight trains every now and then that runs out of Race Pond. Well, of course, there's only one freight train that goes into Jacksonville. The other five go down to Callahan Sub, so it hasn't picked it yet. So I'm waiting for that sort. Now, of course, you can spawn that train if you're, but we got stuff to run. So we had stuff to make up in the yard, and I think we have enough cars in Jacksonville to keep us busy. But we spent this weekend, I'd say we'd spent a good 6 hours on this. And I'm talking to my son and I. This is the same guy that, you know, you get about an hour or so, he just gets bored. No, he was into this. And the reason why he was into it is because it was our rules. We weren't in some part of a set system. This is why single player is actually very intriguing to a lot of people, because they don't have to fall. They can run whatever they want, and that's all we did. We just, you know, we had Amtrak trains down the line that were sitting there and not doing nothing, and there was trains that really didn't mean anything. They just spawned whenever, and we'd run them. What we ended up doing was to so that we can get the trains to delete out of the system, we would t instead of running the intermodal. We would run them instead of running the intermodal yard. What we would do is we'd run them through Jacksonville and around the Honeymoon Y, and then that way they would come in, they would make a total 180 and head back into the yard up to that one line that goes, I think, to, I don't know what the hell it goes to, but there's one line that dead ends, and it's important to have a line that dead ends because you need a way to eliminate it. So we'd run it that way, and then all the outbounds would come out through the north entrance of Jacksonville ramp. And I don't think the industries were, I don't think they were set up, but we'll get into that in a little bit. Now tonight I'm going to go into probably, if you're wondering about the main content of tonight, I'm going back into the California industries. So, hold on to your hats if you're waiting for that. If not, you're going to hear some personal sob stories and, family stuff and all this other stuff. But you will hear a little bit of single player, and I'll show you what I mean. So the next 15 minutes, it's 4:45 in the East. Next 15 minutes, I mean, if you like to hear some of my personal stories with my son and how certain things are going and everything, hang on. If not, go, if you're watching me live stream, I don't know how many I kind of announced it kind of short notice, but if you're watching my YouTube, just skip it ahead a little bit or fast forward or whatever. I'll get into some things too in the next 15 minutes as far as the future of the channel, where I want to take it, which way I want to go. I got some supper to cook in a little while. I'm not too hungry just yet, but anyways. So, the beautiful thing about this, and I'll just go into it right now. And so when we have select scenarios, we go into the world. And as you can see, the name of this is the one that comes with it. The HRS version 2 world template, and we started that out, and then we changed it to the fourth, but we saved it and went back into it. So over the last 2 days, we're just saving it and going back into it. And of course, this is called "Baby Pooped His Diaper." It's like, what the heck? I like to be a little juvenile with my son, get him happy and everything. He's a really happy kid. He's got a good mom, despite what issues we ever had. We get along fine. We're fine for it, but we do everything we can. So he's a good, he's got a good mom. I wish things would have worked out differently, over 5 years, well, a little over 5 years ago now. So, but they didn't, and it's the way things are. I moved on. I guess she's moved on. I dated at least, I had one date relationship, one major relationship. Since then, she's never dated. She's just a stay-at-home mom with her, takes care of Emmett, gets home from school, and I try to get him as much as I can. I see him on weekends, 42 hours on a weekend. I see him like Tuesdays, Thursdays. I see him. Oh, what do we see him now? I see him about 3 hours, pretty much every, be it Tuesday, Thursday. I come to see him at karate, finish up there. Saturdays he has karate all week. That's becoming his big thing, a big activity now besides soccer. So he's got a lot of stuff to keep him busy. So, but anyways. I'll go into it, and I'm gonna explain what the hell that's all about. But I'll show you the world in single player, and this is so it's generated. It's only got 81 trains right now, and we actually worked the Florida East Coast inbound. This is why I was saying I wish it had a Florida East Coast spot. And there's the engines. We just left it in the middle there. It doesn't matter. You do what you want, and. Dispatch board's lit up. I'm not going to save this. I'm just going to show you. So we got the Amtrak's running. We had a couple meets there. We had a CSX come in. So I mean, it's all set. The Amtrak's set to leave, and everything's cool. What happened was I saw a Florida East Coast train that was sitting over here, and I decided to move it or bring it in. So I brought it in, and I actually lost the FEC engines, which is fine because I can just respawn them again. But I couldn't find a place over on this side to keep it trapped. Now, mind you, I could have stopped it, but because there's stub end, I didn't really know what to do. I'm not sure what to do with this yard yet, or how to organize it, or how to play the interchange. The only thing I can think of doing here is getting it set up like a basically like a I guess the word staging, just like a model railroad type thing, like a staging type thing. But no, I ran it right down the main line and just got it out of there. But we brought a train in, we got the switcher going, we found all. Now, like I said, there's old tags and new tags that you will see. And when I say old tags, what I mean by old tags is these ones without the trains. They just have, I shouldn't say they always like that because sometimes they come from industries like that as well. But the new tags are what I like to call, where is it? Here they are. See right there? We see a train name, you see A759, you know what train it belongs to, you know that came from some type of automated tag. Or a spawn, I should say. That's likely came from a spawn. So everything's there. Here's some other ones here. So we had lots to do. We were looking at Taft, but we didn't have enough inbounds. You look at the industry lists. You can play around with the industries. Right now, I mean, I can go in because I'm in single player, and I'm going to be doing this in California very shortly. You can go in and you can check out all the industries and modify them and do whatever you want. And I'll show you later tonight how to do this. So we're probably trying to get to what the hell's this thing about the baby pooped his pants thing. That is a little background story on this. The whole thing with the baby pooped his pants. I don't think that signals a good example. I'm just trying to think if there is a good signal somewhere I can use. Probably out here would be a good one. Benson Junction maybe. It's probably a good signal. Well, of course that's going to be the target. Ha. Okay. Bad example. Those are bad examples. Let me go further up then. Let me go down here. How about that? I got this one. Yeah, that might work. Do they work good? Yeah, they work pretty good. This is what we ca I commonly refer to as Big Baby. I don't know why. Whenever I see these type of signals, and I know they're very commonplace on the A line. And there's also some searchlight signals as well. They just look like little small things, because you look beside the train, it's just like wow. So I call them big babies. And he got a kick out of that because I called them big baby, and that's just the name. That's the common name I give these signals is big babies. They look like big babies to me. I don't know why. I have no idea why I came up with that. I just did. I happened to be with my son, and of course, he starts laughing hysterically and thinks it's hilarious. Well, what had happened was we were switching over here. I got trains coming in now, which, okay, it doesn't matter. I ain't gonna do nothing. Was it over here I was switching? Or we were switching, sorry. I'm not way over here. Here, trains. Oh, that's the Amtrak. Okay. So the Amtrak's there. We brought that in. So we were switching Moncrief here. And I started referring to these guys here. And the little small ones, I just call them little baby. I mean, I don't know why I called them that, but that's why the title came into Baby Pooped His Diaper, or whatever the heck we called it, was because we were switching a train and I was going back to the dispatch board to try to. Here's the engine we were using. And we were pulling cars out, and we had all the switches set up. We didn't split any switches or anything. I just kept on going back and doing a little bit of dispatching for a few seconds while it was running. And I don't know what. We got distracted for a moment, and all of a sudden, we realized our string was down here. And I was like, oops, I put it in control. I put it, go right back to the cab. I was able to get into the cab, and I didn't have to put it into emergency. I actually, well, it didn't matter anyways because I bled all the air, so theoretically, it wouldn't have worked, I don't think. But I b went full dynamics, full independent. It was set below 10 miles an hour, and. And I just I we were coming up to the signal at for the NS Diamond, and I said baby says stop. And we hadn't named this world yet. This was the first day we were doing this back on Saturday, I think it was. And he just He just loved it. I mean, he was having, but the thing that he likes about it is he loves playing around. He loves switching. He's got something called Train Player. I think it's up to 6.4. I bought him that. And he just goes crazy. He loves building the routes in his yards. He's actually built a California in his version, in Train Player. Now, mind you, I mean, he's 8 years old and to know where all the tracks are or the operations. But this was, I mean, he goes to me with the Model Railroad Club, and I'm tired of going to the Model Railroad Club. I really am, because I got to go an hour and a half to there, an hour and a half back. In Canadian dollars, it costs me, it's actually rebate. It's normally 35 a month, in Canadian dollars, but because I'm a distant member, we get 50% off. So it's 17.50 a month. Well, the only problem is they changed things this year. We used to have sessions all the way through except the summer. Well, now this year they decided to do it every other month because certain things like Thanksgiving and Christmas were causing issues. So now we do it January, March, May, July, September, November. So I went to the November session this year. I went to the September session this year so far. But, July, I'm going to take that train trip out. So I'm not going to be able to see it. I'm not going to be able to go to the club, and who knows what's going to happen in the winter because we might lose a session there. So it's getting really expensive. And I mean, he follows me around, and he really love, kids love model railroads. It don't matter whether it's operational or not. He just loves because he can explore and find the activity that interests him. If he's bored or whatever, but we go 6 hours straight of operating sessions now. We used to do 3 hours and an hour and a 3 hour, but I mean, we had a great weekend. So we spent a good 6 hours switching this, and I'll tell you, it was this was a rewarding experience for me because this was something outside the servers where I finally got him into Run8. Besides just wanting to do wrestling. So now I got another program that he likes to do. So that means Entropia Universe, unfortunately, has fallen to a lower level on the totem pole. Of course, that's the one that is technically doesn't cost me anything. Well, it does cost me money, but it's more of an investment because you make money in Entropia Universe if you play it right. And we were doing that. We had our character and everything, and I asked him to have I says, we haven't played Entropy Universe for a few weeks now. Now I got like things that are like stocks and they're making money, and it's the only time I play that game is when when I'm with him. I didn't I otherwise I don't care. I don't want to be shooting up things for 2 hours. It's boring as hell. So I guess for him it's boring as hell now too. The idea of winning a little bit of money on a hunt is not so appealing anymore. But the thing is, it's like a gambling type thing, although there's also investments involved, and we do have investments. And the good thing is, if I'm not spending money hunting, I'm actually got money tied up where I actually make money. So I got this one coal train going through. But see, this is why you go into your single player. It's just like a world. And yeah, you got to dispatch all this and what have you. I got trains stopped everywhere. Who cares? This is the actual. There's probably more activity out here than there would be here, but otherwise, you just run it at your own pace. It doesn't have to be perfect. And if you want to run a main line, then just pick one up that gets spawned and try to dispatch. And I know some people are saying, I don't want to dispatch themselves and everything. So, but it's pretty cool for single player. I think it's fun. What I'll do is, I don't know what I do. I have him set up. How far do I have him set up for? Because I should start cooking supper. So maybe I'll run this for a tiny bit. Then I'll switch over to California. I don't even know how far do I have him set up for? Oh, I never got the Amtrak going. Well, that was a doofus move. Had the wrong signal on. I don't know. These signals are kind of difficult to figure out sometimes. So I had them in this track, I guess. Oh, because I reversed them that way. Oh, I see. It's a different ladder. So, yeah, he's doing his crew change, but then there's another guy that's coming in. I think he's. Yeah, Q133 is going to come around this way. And then what else was I going to do? Oh, I haven't even set him up yet. That's the coal train, right? Yeah. Okay, so I'll set him up. I don't even know what I got set up going this way, to be quite honest. I don't even see anything. So I get him going. And yeah, I can get him going that way. No, I want you to turn off. I can't wait till external dispatcher comes to this, because this board's tough. I don't know what it is about this board. It's tough. Actually, you know, I'll just bring him to here. I will bring him down St. John's that way, like I was going to, because I have that other train coming, so. But that'll stop, and then I'll be able to link up the other train that comes in, because there's one that's just out of town that's coming in as well, so he'll. Well, maybe we'll ride him. We'll ride him. Where is he? Is that him there? Oh boy. I don't know if that's the one I wanted. I think it was, actually. Oh yeah, it is. Okay. Set this up for a moment just to keep. I think we got the Amtrak coming. I think. Yeah. So we got the Amtrak going. I'm going to start cooking supper here and then. Yeah, it's going to go a little bit longer, unfortunately, in this kind of thing because I got to get my supper started at least. Get that out of the way and then I'll share some stories or whatever. And maybe I'll just do a little bit of Florida if you haven't seen. If you guys haven't seen Florida, it's a really cool route. I'm sorry I haven't been on the server, because I really want to get on the server, but just give me a few minutes here. Here comes that Amtrak train I was talking about, but I'll get that lined up, and then maybe I'll get him lined up to go. I'll show you the path I take him through the intermodal area around Jacksonville, and then I'll show you some stories while I start that up, so just give me a few minutes and I'll be right back.
We're going by coming into Jacksonville now. Be right there. Another train at Racebond. Again, I mean, you can run them if you want. If they're not in your area and they don't bother you, you don't have to run them. It helps if you're going to save a world to try to keep it as fluid as you can. I'm just doing this just to keep you guys entertained, at least for the next... I know I said I was going to start at 5, and then I thought, you know, I might as well get supper out of the way. It's a TV dinner. Typical me, you know. But I figure, yeah, I'll get that out of the way first. There's two tracks that go that way. I thought there was only one. Oh, one's a stub. I don't know. I haven't run Florida in a while, so... It's fairly new for me, but from a dispatching standpoint, see all this right here. Watch this. If you're dispatching, and this is a very easy trick, you can do this in F3. It's very easy. See, I've already got him going through. He's holding at St. John's, but watch this. Watch this right here. I'm gonna. He's already through the line here, right? That's one intermodal or coal, or I think it was a coal train that went through, because I'm on the intermodal right now. I'm going to flick that switch. Okay. And I'm going to set that up to another clear again. So that is going to follow this route. And the reason why it's going to follow that route is it's going to eventually pop out. But you want to try to keep things fluid as much as possible. Now this train here is a... Whoa, there's Q457. That's the train I've been waiting for. Oh, dang. I wonder if that's going to do that again with my... Be interesting to see. I'm like, damn, I've been waiting for that train. That is the... 457 is the one that comes into Moncrief, Jacksonville. So, maybe I should save it. I might do that too. I'll explain to my son. I'm gonna say, you know, I ran dispatch for about half an hour. Hope you didn't mind, buddy. Like he's gonna care. But that's, see how this is flashing now? So that's as easy as you can. You don't need external dispatcher, although I prefer external dispatcher. And then, you know, you're looking at these, like the different meets you got here. I mean, there's hardly anything. I got an Amtrak running this way. If you want to hide it, right mouse click. This is all in the information too. So this Q178, we'll just keep him going a little bit. Some of these, normal or reverse, I can't barely even see that from my couch because I'm on a big screen. It is almost impossible. You also lose the east and west designations, so now I forget which trains they are. I had these designations set up and they're gone. I know some people in single player have complained about that. Yeah, I know what you mean. I hear. I feel your pain. The best way to continue that is to probably keep a few signals in front of them and hopefully remember or whatever, but you know, it is what it is. So I might say that I'm going to leave those guys alone. I don't care what they're doing. We're just going to worry about going through Jacksonville through the supper hour. So he's going to get once that train goes through, this is going to line us through Carnegie around Honeymoon Y and into the Jacksonville ramp. So that's going to be our fun. This guy can keep going and then I'll save it. Amtrak's going to go. I want to make sure I put Amtrak the right way. I don't know why that went yellow. That's strange. Because the Amtrak's got to go that way. Yeah. Okay. I got to go back to cooking my dinner again. What do I got? A red signal here? Is it red? What's up with that? Oh, I got a train. I still got that train in front of me, I guess. Or do I have, no, I got that lit up. Everything's hunky-dory. I thought that was red. Maybe it was yellow. I don't know. It looked red to me. Unless it just lit up or something, but that's me there, even though it shows me way back there, but
It would make sense if it was red, but I guess it's middle. That's scary. It almost seemed like it was red. I don't know. Maybe I missed it. Not a big deal. Okay.
I gotta flip my turkey or whatever the hell I have to do. Nice day weather-wise. That's another reason why we picked this particular day. The weather is a lot more clouds outside the desert too, so you get a lot more of that. So I'll be right back. Again, I don't want to... Well, let me grab a drink here first. Get that out of the way. Yeah, as I was saying, I don't want to knock the Selkirk Mohawk route. I just wish it was a little bit more... I mean, there's not even a base world or... I think there's some industries, but there's really not much of a save or anything to really get yourself started in it. And like I said, I don't even know how much it got tested for AI or operations. And I mean, these guys are busy doing it. I don't want to knock it. Like I said, it's the most beautiful route there is. But this one is a good combination of both beautiful scenery and operations, because it is close enough to be set up as one of the easier ones to run, where you don't have to worry too much about running trains. Some of the people in single player, they'll complain about that. I've always wanted to build a route that was in my area where, you'd see maybe a dozen trains a day. I mean, freight-wise, I mean, on one line you see one going one way, one going the other, just like this line. Because you get outside of Jackson, or sorry, going into Jacksonville, then the one that comes out, then there's another one that just, it's like one train a day. That's all there is. So I really don't want to knock it. I just, like I said, I wish that was in there. It is not. Hopefully it'll be set up in a future upgrade. Hopefully there's at least a bit of an editor so that we can put in our own spawn points. I'd like to see if there's a lot of things I'd like to see improved. And don't get me wrong, I have a whole list of things, but this version 2, far exceeded my expectations. I mean, far. It really did. I'm not on the Kool-Aid. I'm willing to, say, this should have been done and that should have been done. I get that. But the way it just, makes it a lot more fun. It is. Version 2 actually made Run 8 enjoyable for my son and I. And he was already excited about the AI. He was already excited about some of the various things. The train just deleted itself. He was already excited about the things that Version 2 had. And he loves to see a new engine come through. He loves to see new things start popping into the world. He loved the Conrail engines when they first came. He's big on Conrail. I don't know why. He just is. So when those things started popping up, see, there's a slow clear there. So I don't know what signal I might have read there. I might have read it wrong, or I just wasn't looking or something. But we're already clear for honeymoon, which kind of made sense because I figured we would be. The only thing I could think of is I just didn't read that signal wrong or change in the last minute. It wouldn't matter. He would have stopped, but... So,
I haven't even shown, of course, the A line itself, the bulk of that main line, and it's fun actually being on. Here's another thing I'll say. I wish they had, and I've mentioned this I think before too, is having the new Amtrak equipment. That new Amtrak equipment. As far as I know, the old stuff you cannot get on and ride. As far as I know, I haven't been able to do it. Holy crap! Did they increase the traffic on that bridge? I don't run Florida very often, but I don't remember that much traffic on that bridge before. Maybe it's me. And if you're commenting on the live stream, I don't watch the comments on the live stream. I really don't. I see comments coming in when I come back in to set up another one. This is the screen I see. So, if you're commenting on the live stream, you can comment in the comments of the YouTube. I check out all the comments in the YouTube, and then there's some people sending me private messages in YouTube. I'm talking about various things, and I have no idea. I don't know. There's some weird conversations. It's like I'm so personal with people that I'm part of their lives or something. I don't know. Or I've become part of their lives. I can't explain it. At some point, I just draw the line and say, okay, well, this is getting a little bit weird. But I won't get into that, though, because I appreciate the comments, whatever it is, whatever you want to say. I appreciate that all. Let me go grab my supper here. I'll head around Honeymoon Y here. Saying that my son, he was having a rough time for a while. He was really, he was waking up and getting upset while he was here, and saying how much he missed me and everything like that. And I can understand that, because I felt that way, and he was not getting as much enjoyment out of school anymore. He was bored at home. What the heck? That was weird. I don't know what that was. I didn't type. I wasn't typing. I just decided to do that. It's weird. Sometimes these things just honk all of a sudden, do weird stuff. I don't care. They can do their random honks and whatever they want to do. That wasn't me. I'm here eating my dinner. Makes you wonder, though, because I've had some weird stuff happening with my computers lately. But anyways, I'm going about my son, and yeah, he's been actually good the last 2 weeks. Last weekend was a tough weekend for me because I had that long weekend. I didn't seem like I caught everything that I wanted to do. I took the U.S. long weekend off. Those were two vacation days. Had a somewhat stressful week at work last week. It looks like things are starting to improve. As of Monday, things will look like some stuff, some freight moved as it was supposed to. It was already behind today, but it started moving. I checked on the weekend. Actually did that with my son. I showed him a couple ships that were out in the Atlantic Ocean that had freight on, as well as a truck that was crossing the border Friday night into not too far from me in Niagara, Southern Ontario. So it was kind of cool. So I think things are looking pretty good for next week, but I was getting down again. We had such a great weekend. And I was supposed to see Ski today, but he had some work or something he had to go out of town tomorrow, as of tomorrow, so he didn't have the time. But so I was kind of looking forward to that, but that, you know, things like that happen. And I think that may have just that whole long period. It's such a long time on Sundays. He goes at 1 o'clock, and then I am just trying to fill. And last Sunday was not a good. I was really actually down last Sunday. Not only was I a little bit down, or I don't know if it was with him necessarily, or not seeing him, or because the long weekend was over, or what it was, but I wasn't myself. And I had some things going on at work too, different stuff, freight and stuff like that, but because of the long weekend. It happened again this weekend. I started feeling down today. Not so much this morning, although I woke up a little early. But he's been fine. Except he starts sensing when I'm down. I'll sense when he's down, and I'll know it. And I kind of felt it towards the end that he was starting to get down too, because now he was sensing that I was down. It's amazing. And I never had that growing up because I don't know, I just didn't, maybe because I was adopted, I don't know, but I didn't have that sense of knowing when my son was feeling a certain way, or knowing how my dad was feeling. I just don't remember that. Okay, so we got a train at Winokur side, I ain't gonna worry about that, let that do its thing. I'm just gonna ride this in, and I'm gonna delete that. Or I'm not going to resave the territory. Him and I will deal with it. Even though I'm missing out on that manifest train that I was kind of looking forward to. Running a daylight too, and I told him, I says, well, even if it's dark, we can change the light if that helps. So we started just before dawn. We started this at like 5 o'clock in the morning or whatever it was in the simulator. And I don't know, he may not be interested in running at night. Not much to see, so he probably gets bored of it, you know. Although I love some of the lighting. I enjoy running at night sometimes. Especially when, you know, you're in the cab and you get the street lights flashing on you and everything.
is a pretty cool experience, is just running an AI train down here. And I mean, you can enjoy that. I mean, you, like I said, there was that pet peeve of mine, and I got a bunch of them, like I said. We got that nice new Amtrak equipment. First of all, we have a bunch of stuff that we don't even have yet that's spawning AI, like UP Aces that are running, that are spawning, that we can't even buy. But yet, so they end up spawning in the Run8 libraries. But yet, the Amtrak trains, from what I can tell, do not spawn the new ones. That's kind of a disappointment, but like you say, you can spawn your own thing, you can create your own save files, or, you know, you don't have to totally rely on the AI, although, you know, I prefer to. That's just me. I like to have it all inclusive, I know it's 525, I know I keep promising it, and we're running out of time. Trust me, I'm just going to finish this. We'll be in Jacksonville ramp, and then I'll go into California, and we'll start playing around with the industries, because we want to get California set up a little better. And there's some really cool tricks that I found out. I've been. You can really play around with this system. I already found my original experiment was to get them, to get the industrial switchers online, so that you can have the train still tag it and bring it into that industry and not affect its tag or emptying or loading. Easy way to do that. You just, he must be clear of the switches because he's starting to speed up. Yeah, you just change the you change it for a car that is never gonna go there, like a passenger car or an intermodal car in an industry, and you just that's how you get it to get on your switch list so that it goes over. So it actually, it'll actually spawn. It's in a different video, but then I started playing around with the hump. And what was it? The hump that I did first? Maybe it wasn't. Well, I guess that was the latest experiment. Was you can get it so that you make any switcher that runs in Barstow, it don't matter if it's a hump, trim, whatever, it's a switcher, so just call it Y-bar-bar, and then assign that for the train, and then start putting industries for all your tracks in Barstow, be it the receiving yard, you can do it to the departure yard too, I think, although, you know, it doesn't matter. But what happens is it ends up showing up on the switch list. So now you have, instead of having to go into the tagger of each and every one, all you gotta do is go into your switcher or go into the list or whatever you want to go into, and you will see those cars. You don't have to export it to a list. I mean, it's there. Not like before, because if it's sitting in an industry someplace, you have no record of it. You cannot find it. If it's on a main line coming inbound, you cannot find it. So the only way it will show you is if it is relinquished and at an actual industry in the system. That is the only way it will show up on a list that it's actually there, or it's on a train that is assigned to that industry. So if it's on a train that's assigned to it, then boom, it will show you that indeed you have a particular number of cars. Now, if you don't have any cars that are assigned for those yard tracks, which would be none, it's not going to show you a set off. What it will do is it will show you it'll show you where your pickups are. And your pickups will include everything that is in that area. So, works like a charm.
And this is good for trying to figure out what's in Barstow. I don't know how it's going to work with the hump. I haven't seen that yet. And of course, if I'm going to be doing the hump, I'm going to be doing it with California. But I believe it's once it's relinquished. I think it's as long as it's humping, it's not going to show up or populate until it's actually relinquished or part of the bowl. We'll have to see how that goes. It probably needs some testing, but then again, it has no influence on the waybills whatsoever. So it's not going to start asking for traffic going to Barstow. All it is a reporting function. And like I said, it works like a charm. I just did a couple tracks the other day, and it just like, yep, this is how I do it. Now, mind you, that's not my top priority for California. My top priority is to get the industries working more efficiently and to eliminate stuff like grain cars and auto racks showing up in Barstow, plugging up my yard or West Colton or wherever. We don't want them there. We don't want them to come into manifest trains. We want them to come into the unit trains, as far as I know, anyways. I could be wrong on that one, but as far as I know, definitely the intermodal stuff, but that wasn't happening. It was the grain stuff that was showing up. So you have all this extra, or coal is another one. You don't want that. If you got unit coal, you do not want it coming up as an industry request. So you set it to one. Like Tom was mentioning in the forums today, he was saying how he's got the coal plant set up for 1 hour intervals. So that when it's set off, within 1 hour, it switches out. I thought that was a pretty good idea. Why not? Now in some places you don't want to have heavy changes in demand, but for a coal place or whatever, if somebody wants to run it, yeah, why not? Have it do its thing, and you're all set, right? Wow, this is a longer route than I thought it was. Get around the other side. So, well, it's 5:32. I'm not going to make it into the ramp because this is longer than I thought it was. Oh, another one to go into the pile here of stuff that I have to take out for recycling. Did that work? What the heck? There we go. Holy crap. Alright. Feels like my glasses have a smear. I gotta get these non-smearing glasses. I don't even know where the hell we are. I know we're back in the honeymoon. Whatever section. Coming up to it. I'm not going to keep it going though. I know I could, but maybe I will. I'll save it. Why not? I don't know if I should have shown that on a live stream. Actually, it's linked up to my computer, so that doesn't matter. So I think it's fine. I didn't mean to do that. I was looking at the license to try to help somebody out earlier. Save as. So baby pooped his diaper. We will resave that. Yes, that's the name of my world. I'll go back to the main menu. And we are going to go into I'm going to go into the Southwest, it doesn't matter where I'm at, extra board is fine. Head up over to Barstow because all I'm doing is changing the configuration. So this part is where I get into the industries and what have you. I'm going to take a look at the forum just to see what's happening. And yeah, we were trying to help a new member there. He was having... oh wow, San Bernardino's running now. Well, that's different. A yard. Okay, that's nice. So open the server tab. There's two options: host and client. You want to be on client. Below that is a white area with several probably blank columns. First one is a server name. Put whatever you want here. Second is a server password. Enter the password Tom emailed to you. Yeah, never repeat it in the forum. Address is fine. I don't care. And the cool thing about too is your server list, it actually shows you when a server is down or who's on it. If there's no number showing up, it means the server is down. If the number is showing up zero, it means nobody's on it, client-wise. Otherwise, it'll show you any other number of clients that may be on. I'm not going to show you that, for example, because I don't want to show you my passwords anymore. I'll show you enough stuff here. So that's San Bernardino. So that's, I wanted to see if there was any other. I don't have any other updates, so I'm going to keep on going here into California. Now, do I was going to, I had a file going on where I was getting into all the various industries, and I'm not too sure where I put that. So Southern California, man. Industry configuration, open office. What do I got? Two of them here? One's a spread. I think they're both spreadsheets. I think one is. I don't know why I got two of them going on here. I got three actually. Industry. Well, industry car report. I don't think I need that one, but I'll take a look at it anyways. I don't think I want that. No, that's just a car. That's a car report that's showing you where everything is, blah blah blah. No. Now I'll go into the file and open it from here. I want to go into, do I get that? Yes. I think I want the 27. Yeah, think that's what I want. I have no idea what those numbers are. The ones and sixes and all that other crap. I don't even know what the hell I was thinking there. Is that hump tracks or something I was doing at one point? I don't know. I have no idea. I'll leave them in there for now just for the hell of it. Okay. So yeah, this is going to go into our various industries. Now, when you're dealing with, I'm not going to go into the details of every single industry to make sure that there's actually cars there. But I do want to see what's happening at some of these said industries. So I will start off the list at 84. And this one I get rid of. I don't want that. I will close this. So we'll go here, and yeah, I will go into each and every one of these industries to see what we've got going on. If I see something that is flashing red at me like this, then I'm gonna take it out. For example, Barstow. I don't care if there's two blocks at Barstow. I don't know what that means. It doesn't give you specifics. Oh, wait a minute. It says Barstow. Never mind. Forget that. Never mind. I'm dumb there. So yeah, Bar Fresno, Bar Pass. Yeah, that's fine. It's going to Barstow via, or it's going to Barstow or Fresno via Barstow. Okay, I get that. So we'll transport to the industry. It's going to do the configuration. Oh, which I believe this is in Kern. Is this Kern Y? I think it's in Kern Y. Ooh. Oh yeah. This is Kern. I recognize it. So now, normally it will show up. I don't know if it ha you have to hit edit tracks first. And there they are now. So it shows you which ones. It shows you it's all the way to the switch, actually, if you want it, but that's fine. Do I have to save it? I guess I do. That's fine. Because I haven't changed any others. So, see, it's not red anymore. I thought there was a way it would show up. Oh, it does. It shows it right here. See? Oh, when you go into the industry, then it shows you. Okay, gotcha. Now I get it. So we go advanced drainage. See, now it's gone. But if you go back to it, see, now it shows up. Okay, perfect. So advanced drainage. I'm going through each one of these. Actually, you know something? I'm just going to go through my gut instincts is what I see happening. Fresno, whatever those other ones are, I don't know. I'll transport to it and take a look. And there they all see, and they're down there, right? So it's asking for three of them. Question is, can it hold three in that little area? And if there's overage, that's fine, but yeah, I guess hard to see, right? I don't know if they would show up better in the dark or what, but they're there. I can see. Okay, hey, you know. Oops. Now let's see if that shows up a little better. So I'm not interested in the how everything looks. Oh yeah, look at that. See? So there's a trick right there. Oh, and it does go back as far. See, I didn't even see it go back that far. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. So you set it to a time that's dark enough where you can actually see the red in the cyans, right? Actually, the cyans won't show up in this. So we go AFG, it disappears. Looking at this now, that's perfect. Everything there, it looks like BNSF, West Colton, North Platte. That one, I don't know what that is. I just don't know. Let me AFG, I don't even know what the heck. They're asking for two and a 96-hour turnaround to go to Bakersfield. The problem is it's going to go to Bakersfield. It's going to empty and head to Bakersfield, and then we don't know where it's going. So there's a lot of things that you can do to help that. I just don't know why it's supposed to, they need to send a tank car to Bakersfield for, except that it's closer. I'm thinking that maybe if it's going to do that, then perhaps forward it to Fresno. Because it's either this, I mean, you're getting into trains here where it's like, okay, well, what train's it going on? It's going to go to Bakersfield, but then where does it go? It doesn't have a purpose. And though if you're sending it just to Bakersfield, then you have to go back into the whole tagging system. Well, what actually calls for that demand now? If you're going to use the AI system or the AI industry configuration system, what calls for that demand? The only thing I can think of, if you're trying to restrict it, Let me see AFG. Where's I should get the maps out just to be on the safe side, but it's at it's Cal 441, so my transport over there, and I'll hopefully recognize it. Wow, I thought the other one. Oh, it's in the plant too. Holy crap! Where is this? I don't even recognize that now. Wow. That's kind of cool. I just don't recognize where this is. AFG. Do I have to get my maps out again? All right. Fine. Let me hold off on this one. I'll go back into it in a minute. It'd be really cool to have a thing that shows up in the F3 that actually says you're closest to this thing. At least then I can get an idea, yeah, right around the neighborhood. Okay, so AFG, this one I'm not even using right now, so let's just kill that. I don't think I need to. We'll go into the PDF of, I believe it's, I gotta think it's Mojave, but I'm not sure. It sounds familiar, but I don't know. The problem is I'm gonna be opening a bunch of these in a minute. No, maybe not. It's not gonna be out there. AFG. Sounds like something like needles or, oh, wait a minute. Hang on a second now. I'm thinking I might know where it is. PPG Aerospace. It's not there, but I got a funny feeling I might know where it is now. Do I have the new stuff? That's Button Willow. Okay, wait a minute. What's the date of this? That doesn't tell me. January 20th? Say what? I got the January 20th one? Are you kidding me? I haven't downloaded the latest and greatest. Okay. Well, maybe I'll do that. So if you want to know where the latest and greatest is, folks, this is where you go. Go to Run8 Depot. And they have the latest information. They have information on some of their servers. They got a, I don't know, you're pretty cool. I'm gonna have a photo op or something. Pretty cool. I've seen them do like little photo op things before, but I've been here before as far as like references. I'll use that for. I don't use the forums, but I definitely use the references and the maps. So we want to go up to, wow, that's a cool shot. There's a new picture. I don't remember that picture in there. I've seen new pictures pop up here from user contributed pictures that'll pop up. That one I didn't remember. Okay, so that's November 19th. Let me download that. And I'll put that into, I think I put that in my pictures. Yeah, so I'll replace that. Yeah, perfect. I don't know if I have the latest of all of those, so let me just double check here. I'll go back out here for a moment. I'll go back into here, check my pictures out. Not worried about A-line right now. Barstow. I got a funny feeling those are going to be old. February 16th. No. Oh, no. We don't have to do that. We'll have to do Barstow if we have it, if it's available. So, February 16th, Cajon. Do I have the latest? Nope. January 23rd. I'm not worried about Mohawk at the moment. Needles.
Yeah, oh, okay, I have it. I gotta do them all. Okay, fine. Let's do them all. They have them all. And whatever changes are in there, it'll tell you. So it's all there. So that's UP Mojave. Let's do Cajon. I'll download that. Put that into. Yeah, we want it there. Does it? Oh, I don't want to do that. I don't want to have a copy of a copy. Is that what it's doing? Is that what the heck it did last time? Huh. I don't want a copy of a copy. I want the real deal. Just replace the thing. Yes, I want to replace it. What do you think I'm here for? needles. I don't know if they have an updated Barista or not. I didn't really. They got UP West Colton over here. Oh, here it is. Let me see if they have a later one. Yeah. Okay. Individual. I think I'll. I don't know if I'll. What does a full map look like? Download map, full page. Because I don't. You know something? I don't really print these. Although that's a little difficult to see, because then you got to zoom in on everything, right? Yeah, I don't know if I want to go that far. Nah, let me do the individual pages. Yeah, I'll deal with that instead. Okay, good enough. Has that changed any? It says November 19th, 2016, so. I guess it has. Getting a pretty good. Oh, yeah, West Colton. Individual pages. I never had, or at least I didn't have it saved. Have I done Cajon yet? Or did I just do it? Maybe I did. So that's gonna have the other ones, and that's where I'm thinking it might be. Okay, let's do Cajon. I think I did. I'm pretty sure I did. I'm just. Yeah. Okay. So needles. I think this is the last one. I probably. No, I haven't done that one. Okay. That's back in October. I can't remember. I'll get it anyways. I don't think it's changed anything else. So I can get out of there. Got everything I need there. I don't think I have any other information that I have to get from here for now. Yeah, this is the thing with new users are coming on and they're seeing that they can't get to a dispatcher board, and they're wondering why. It's like that's why. So let's see here. So now I'm gonna open up.
We'll start with, I want to go to Mojave now because I got a funny feeling I know where it is. What the hell was this name of the industry now? I can't remember. Oh my God. What can I say? What we got? 5:55 p.m. Wow, that's neat how that does that. AFG sounds familiar. Oh, I know where that. I think that's on Needles. Because this whole area is starting to look familiar. Some of these I just haven't switched before, so I really don't know, but okay. I think it's either going to be. I don't think it's down. No, I think it was definitely out that way, not that way. So they got Chimera Water Solutions as that little yard there. That's interesting. We were debating setting it up for the Trona train. But it's interesting though because once you have the cars, we can't spawn it. I gotta get a paper. Or no, I got a Kleenex here. Perfect. My glasses are bugging me. I think I smeared them with something, what I had for dinner. Let me see here. A little better. I have these non-smear glasses. I got these old glasses, and I just never updated them. So, okay, so Progressive Rail, we did have that. Used to, Chimera Water's another one. What we lose because we can't spawn stuff other than if we go use RTS is the some of the industries that were in there. The Oak Creek branch, for example, there's a lot of stuff in there which I wouldn't mind getting into. So Palmdale cutoff goes to page 10. I'm curious if that how that's going to be added, if it is. But that's interesting. That's that they're using that as Chimera. I don't even know if we have wind tags set up. Probably not. I hope not. Okay, so they're using page 10. Nebo, which really isn't used anymore. I don't know. It's a huge freaking facility, but it just did not have traffic in our area, in our era. USA Services. This is where I'm thinking it might have been, but no. Okay, so we got Vulcan. I haven't even checked that rock loader out. Southern California Edison. I don't know what that is. And then Yermo Yard. The Buttonwillow Branch. Frito-Lay. Nope. Okay, so it's not. Let me minimize that then. Do I have to open up another one? Okay, I'll go over to Needle or not Needles, Cajon, because I think that's where I'm going to find it. Hey, California Steel. Okay. So this is where it gets interesting because now we've got these names. ADM, that was the one I was thinking. Cargill, no. A second. I guess one way to try and help me out is to put the milepost tags on. Milepost 40, I thought so. That's what I was thinking. So that kind of confirms what I was thinking. Milepost 40, it is over here. There it is. See, we never had cars in this area before. So this is all fairly new to me, but that's wow, that's huge. Okay.
It's wanting to send crap back to Bakersfield? See, if it was closer to the other, I would say okay, but it's actually closer to going someplace else. It's BNSF, but ugh. Why does it want to go to Bakersfield? I don't get it. I don't know what it's supposed to be. Tank cars empties because Bakersfield needs tanks, I guess. I don't know. This is where it gets confusing because the way we used to do things is we'd have a supply of empties. That it would pull off the supply of empties. Now, unfortunately, that this isn't going to work for this system, at least not automated, because when it needs an empty, it's not going to. Oh my God. Every time I try to say something, the dog starts barking. But anyways, I just don't know where to put that thing. Tank. You got stuff that's going to Kansas City, you got stuff that's going to Los Angeles, West Colton, North Platte. To me, it should go anywhere or whatever's easier, really. I don't know why it can't go with the rest. But in all honesty, what would happen? Usually, although tanks are a different story, it would actually send it back. Or sorry, it wouldn't send it back. It would actually confiscate the empty. Tanks are a different story though. Those because they're different chemicals and they're blah blah blah, wouldn't be doing that so much. But it would actually send it to the nearest yard, which of course is Barstow, not Bakersfield, and it would. It's either going to go to Bakersfield for a specific industry that's going to load, which in this case we could do that. But what normally would happen in this, and I think this is the idea, is to send it to Bakersfield because those particular industries that serve it is probably over there. So what I'll do, yeah, I do have that. What I'm going to do. Oh shoot, I had it open there for a minute and then do it, then it decided not to do it. I'm gonna put AFG as a. I can't send it to Bakersfield. I could send it to Bakersfield slash or Bakersfield space Fresno. But even that doesn't make sense because, it wouldn't go there. I don't even know if we have. Do we have a train that goes to Fresno from Barstow? I know there's a. There's. Fres. I know there's a Fresno Bakersfield, but I'm not too sure about the other. It's possible, I guess. And the sad thing about the whole system right now, the way we have it set up, is that we have all Bakersfield stuff going. Actually, that would actually come into play because it would go to Fresno, so maybe it would actually work out okay. I don't know. I don't know what to do with it. Let me. Okay. Let me check this in a minute here. I want to see something. 'Cause I'm curious now. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go into our old registry, which we still have online, but we're not using it. Oh wow, I can actually go into those folders or the download folders. That's neat. Instead of having to go to the PDF each time. Okay, I want to check the Barstow matrix for a minute. Wherever it is, there it is. That's what I thought. We have a Fresno Bakersfield train, but we don't have a Bakersfield Fresno train. So what I propose we do then, I'm just looking to see if I can find a Fresno.
I'm probably not going to get this all done tonight. I'm going to take my time and do the rest tomorrow. There it is. Okay, so that's what I'll do. Because we have a train that we're supposed to be sending to Fresno, or at least coming from Fresno. So what I'm going to start doing is I'm going to actually call it BAK space FRS. I think that'll work. I don't know. So that will go into that will that should go into I'm not too sure if it will now. Oh, man. The way the tags are set up with trains and all the other garbage that we got set up now. Oh, crap. I have to check the, I don't have anything going to Bakersfield unless it's specific to an industry. And the only other things that we had going were that the local call-ins. So now I have to literally set up something that's going to make sure that it gets there. But let me just put it, because it's going to end up going into the other, what do you call it? It's going to end up going into the slough track if it doesn't. So what I will do, I'm going to do two things. I'm going to go back to this. And I already have it highlighted red, so that's good. But I will put it as a Bakersfield to Fres Bakers see, this is the old way I used to do things. Here, I'll call it BAKFRS. That's going to be the new designation for that, just so that it actually does move and jeez, it actually moves into that vicinity. So that'll be the tag. So we're all set there. So it's going to be an empty that goes to Fresno. The only reason why I want to get it into Fresno is at least it gets it in that direction, because I guess that's the purpose. If there is a particular industry though that it's needing to go to, like this supplies it, or I have an industry that actually calls for this, then I won't do that. I will actually change it to that industry, but I don't think that exists, because I got a funny feeling it's just a tank that's going back to find loaded oil somewhere coming out of Bakersfield, and that's all that's for. And we don't want that. Or loaded fuel or whatever the heck it's supposed to be. We don't want that because we don't want to be bothered dealing with tags. At least none of us, I certainly don't. So, okay, so that takes care of that one. Agriculture, plastics. Looking at the things, North Platte. Barbell, Bartell, Watt, or Bar Watt. Everything looks okay there. Let me transport. Alrighty. Allon. West Colton, North Platte, West Colton RV. Think we're okay here. Oh, yeah. How many does it take? It takes 9? Well, that's cool. So it only loads them under those areas. See, that's the other thing that people have to get used to is where to spot them. Which is interesting because you can't spot them on the curves. You can't, you gotta spot them right next to that thing. So it's very important people know that. Perhaps we need to do pictures and all kinds of other wonderful things. I don't know. Because they can't access this otherwise, so they got to know where to spot them. Because if it goes into this track over here, if it goes all the way down here, it ain't gonna load. That was Elon Ember. Hold on a second. Did I even check? Yeah, I did. Okay. Amber Chemical. GATX. Oh, nice. Woohoo. Wow. Yeah, that takes quite a bit, huh? Oh man, gotta love those. That's changed a lot from our old the way we had the industry set up before, so that's okay. Everything looks good otherwise. There is some major stuff where I'm going by orders so far, just so that we know what's. Oh yeah, that's that milepost 21 crapola thingamajigga bell, which is fine. Everything's fine. I'm not worried about the hours in these cases. That's fine. ADM. Yeah, right by Colton Crossing. We've never switched this before. I've never switched it. See, it stays away from the curve, so then you know it's got to be, which makes sense. I mean, it's only calling for four cars. People are gonna put it in here anyways, I would imagine, or I would hope. Bakersfield Recycling. Yeah. See how that does that? Yeah, right after the gray. You don't fit, you ain't making it. Is that going to Fresno, wherever else, RV, RO? Fine. I showed you this the other day, huh? See where it says the word junk? That's because it's not calling for passenger cars, I can assure you that. If they start coming in on mixed trains, you'll know why. I don't expect it. I could have kept it intermodal, but I said, let me put a passenger car in there. If passenger cars start showing up, that is going to be the most hilarious thing, but I don't expect it. I don't even know why they're in there, to be quite honest. I know there's a place that takes them, on A line, but I just don't expect that. I really don't. I mean, I'd be surprised. I know it doesn't do the intermodal because we already have intermodal industries. Well, cars, they do not come in. Okay, I'm not gonna go to 103 or 113. Bidart. I'm checking. Oh, okay, see, here's your West Colton right here. So at this point right now, I am just going to. So that puts it against the thing. It's like seven cars closest to the industry. You'll know if the thing never empties. You'll know you have to respot the thing. So I'm getting rid of the WC. I do not want to send crap to West Colton. There's enough stuff going to West Colton there. So let it figure out the rest. I won't mark that on the sheet. I was going to do it to make it to try to figure out why it's going to a specific, but I haven't seen anything going local yet to one yard to another. And that one loads it too, which is scary. I mean, if it loads it and it's going to West Colton, where's it supposed to be going? I don't get that. Big Rock Creek Vulcan. Ooh. 67? Okay. So now here's okay, we got a rock train. We got a this is basically all it is a rock train. It's coming out of it's an open hopper for one. Which I'm not too sure about this one. All right, where are we? Oh boy. Okay. Big Rock Creek, Vulcan. So, this is where things get really interesting, and I'm not too familiar with this industry here. I see this little set off track here. See that thing? Okay, yeah. As far as I know, what will happen here? Hmm. Is it got a runaround? It does. And it has its own controlled siding. Is it a manual switch? I don't know much about this area at all. It's got a manual switch. Perfect. So this is what happens. As far as I know, Vulcan is going to be a candidate for local switching. Now, you could probably not have to have it set up that way, because it's all stuff that's just going back to Savage, and that's all there is to it. So in this case, yeah, you put the industry switcher in there, you call the cars. This isn't telling you, it isn't telling an somebody who's looking for a job, such as an industry switcher, that, hey, look, there's cars out here that can probably be shunted. Because it's calling, it's got a 67 capacity, which means it's calling for a lot of cars. What I'm going to do is this thing right here. I'm going to use Tom's approach, where he changes the capacity down based on one user being able to just bring it in. So I'm going to bring this down, at least for now. All the way to 1. It's going to load this up after an hour. So if somebody wants to switch Vulcan, and that car's come, it gets loaded up in that siding, the train would come around in that siding, and then it would have it would probably, if I don't know which way it comes in the train, but let's say the empties come in and the plant switcher, there would be a plant switcher for here. This would not be a switcher that comes in and just says, okay, here we go. Here's the problem and why we should set it up, and I'm going to highlight this one, because, yeah, see how I have Borax and Borax loader? I'll show you in a minute, because this is going to be a perfect example. You've got Big Rock Creek dash Vulcan, and I don't know what's out there on the server right now, but when you're looking at Vulcan for this one, and it's doing that much in loads, what I'm now going to put is I'm going to put that as setup industry. And that's just a reminder to me that I need to set up the industrial switcher similar to how I did Borax. Now I have set it up for the 1 hour. You don't want that to be able to take so long to load, because you only got that little stretch right there. You got the loader, you bring in so many cars at a time. You're not going to fit 67 cars at a time. But what you're going to do is, assuming the train, I don't even know what directions these trains are coming from. I'm not familiar with this area. You have a unit, excuse me, you have a unit train that comes in. Now, that's the other thing, too, is where is that stuff coming from? Is there a rock train? I don't know. I don't know enough about Vulcan. That's the other thing I should put it, because I don't know enough. I see RVUVU, which is the rock, I guess that's the local freight symbol of a rock, Vulcan, but what the heck? It runs out of UP? So I'm also going to put unit with a bunch of question marks because I need to know if there's a symbol of a train on UP that runs from Savage Mine all the way to Vulcan. I think there is. I'll take a look. But if there is a unit train, and I'm gonna look at this in a minute. I'm gonna see and take a look and see what's set up for it. The problem with the other thing too is these open hoppers are actually doing cold. They're not doing rock. Which is another. I mean, you got a slot for a passenger car. You should have one for a rock. one of your ballast cars. But there might be a way of changing. There might be a way of fixing that. Honestly, I haven't done the experiment, and I'm still experimenting. So, let's just leave that for now. I'll take a look at that later. But we're gonna head right on to the next one, and this goes back to. When we go into Borax, we transport here. Okay. You will see that piggyback flat car is test only, which means it's not changing anything. All it's doing is it's calling nothing. It's not calling, there's no demand coming for this. But what happens is it brings the cars to here and will tell you. It will tell the India industrial switcher who's working the Borax loader, which is the name of the or LCAL 0611 industrial, which is the name of the switcher that works this plant, that hey, there's cars over on the fence track. Because there's the loader over here. All that other stuff is just yard track. There's no loaders or anything else that's going on over there. Now, that being said, we go back to this whole thing about how long do we want to do? Do we want to do 1 hour? I'm not too sure about that. But it's got to bring it over to the fence track for it should not be going into the loader. So it brings the cars over into the fence track. It leaves the Borax switcher deals with that. So this is where it's coming into. So this is the way I have it set up right now. Now, as far as the amount of time it takes, the hours, it don't matter. They all, they could be anything. I'm gonna put it back to 24. Just because, yeah, I don't know if I need to do 24. Yeah, we'll do 24. Why not? We'll make it 24 hours because we want the industry to be able to manage dealing with a certain amount. Now, the problem that we have right now is there might be more that we want to bring in. Quite frankly, I just don't know how to handle it at this point. There are other storage tracks here. I'm not exactly sure how I want to handle boron to do what it used to do. But I brought that down to 24 for now. That what that means is at least it the industry switcher will be able to come in here, do its thing, plop it back. Doesn't mean that you have to run a boron local all the time, but at least it gets it out into there and back into over there. Because if you look at the, everything's still got the same tag. Nothing has changed there. Everything's still using the same tag. It's the local freight symbol that has changed. So if it's in a loader, it's just the way the reporting will go. So that's all that's for. Some of these other industries, I don't like Brown's Lager Company. What, I know what it's named after, but are they real industries? And do we really want to send three cars all the time? But don't even see that one. Oh, here it is. Okay. So I mean, there's a big area. Doesn't matter. So that's, pretty straightforward. Oh, I haven't checked. Sorry, I got to go back to Borax for just a second here. Or Borax loader. Make sure we got all the stuff that we want. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, so see, there we go, right there. No, I didn't even check these. Hold on. We don't want loaded box. First of all, let's just forget the acid tank cars going to Barstow. If they're gonna go somewhere, fine. Go bring them to Los Angeles. Bakersfield, forget it. San Bernardino, forget it. You know what I mean? I mean, what the hell is it going to? We need specific industries on those. So if they're not showing specific industries, and I can see the possibility of having that, but if there's not specific industries, then I don't know how to set that up yet. So that's why I'm taking those out of there. And I'd like to. I'd actually like to have it so that some of the bridge traffic that goes in, it says, oh yeah, that's going to a local industry. Well, that's cool. That's awesome. So that's Borax loader. So I mean, I can keep going on and on about the various changes I make. I just don't know at some point whether or not or what's going to be implemented or whatever. Hang on a second. That's not what I wanted. So I deleted bar. West Colton RV, that's fine, but see, West Colton RV is fine. I forget if I've been mentioning it on the rest of the stuff. Yeah, everything else is there. See, that's going to that specific, at least local destinations. Cargill will be another one coming up, but let's keep going here. We got the Brown's Lager, which is fine. Cargill, that's the one I want to change now. As far as I know. Let's just take a look and see how we got it set up now. Okay. So that's how it's set up to come over this particular track right here. Okay, first of all, capacity, bring it down to one. Again, this, if it's got the cars ready and there's demand and the plant's ready to switch another one, why not bring it? That's the way I look at it. I don't have a problem with it being ready to send, at least not for those particular industries, because you're basically waiting for another cargo switcher to come in, and if somebody wants to run that job, so be it. Eventually the grain it's going to come in, either the grain trains are going to come in or they're not. So I'm setting that to one as well. So anytime we have grain that comes in there, number one, it's going to come in as a unit train, and then from there it's going to set everything up. So West Colton, Fresno, everything else. What the heck is VCW? Is that the name? Oh, jeez. Some of these name VCW. I don't know what VCW is. Is that a name of a like? What is that? What is that? What is that? Vulcan? No, let's just be you. Oh, okay. Now we're at. Whoa. We're at Vul. What's this? I was afraid of this one. I want to go back to Vulcan for a minute. I'm afraid of this one. Oh, crap. Okay. So it's actually going to load up some ballast now too. What was it just? What the hell was it loading before? It was loading up an open hopper of coal. No, it's loading up ballast. Hang on a second here. So it's loading up a bunch of coal for Savage, which it's showing us a rock train. I don't understand this industry. I just don't. But we already had it set up so that it actually comes in and deals with that because there's not that much room for it anyway. So I'm going to put that right back here. Again, I'm going to put this down. The ballast hoppers, okay. Wait a minute. Let me just double check this one more time. I still don't know if they're coming in as unit trains or what, but okay. So, assuming that they're not, so it's going to load up a bunch of ballast hoppers. Which probably doesn't take too long. It's about the same as coal, I guess. Here's where it's interesting. What we can do there for the boxcars is put them down here. Now all of a sudden you're dealing with part of that industry that takes a lot more than just putting it under a little dumpster thingy to load. Ditto with the gondolas. Leave those figures in for 72. What you're doing there is you're causing the industry to actually load up, working it, but waiting for proper loading or whatever of the boxcars in comparison. Now, we don't expect it, to really take necessarily 72 hours. It's up that level because and we don't expect that to be done in 1 hour. Actually, it would be done in a matter of minutes. But the whole idea is the time comparison thing going on. So that's interesting though. So okay, so Vulcan. Oh, the lights are turning off. Daylight's coming. So cargo, we already changed. We already did that. Perfect. Oh, I want to do oh, Cemex. That's another one. See how I got there's Cemex and then there's a Cemex quarry. Ha. This is gonna be good. Okay. So again, we've got loaders. We got all kinds of interesting stuff here. Boxcars, fine. Leave them like that. Open hoppers. Open hoppers, we want that. Open hoppers for CMX. We already have that going into the Oro Grande train now. So we do not want any capacity on those. They're coming in as units. At the same time, we want them to empty out in 1 hour. That way, if somebody's switching the plant, they get to do it. Two bay covered hoppers. Again, where does the coal here? I thought the coal went someplace else here. You mean to tell me they all go into this area here? I'm gonna look around this plant because I got a funny. Let's okay, that's the sun. There's your coal loop right there. As far as I know. I don't see any other locations in this plant that they supposedly. Because I see, okay, here's the thing. I guess that's your cement over there, is what that's saying. So this is where you can almost differentiate different parts of the track. I don't know. I honestly don't know, but a two bay covered hopper. Number one, I don't think we have unit cement trains. So yeah, we do want the capacity of having a bunch of empty cement hoppers coming in from all over the place and then heading off there. But to load them, once again, we want to back that off. It doesn't necessarily have to be one. It could be a higher number. But the idea there is you get a switcher, a CEMEX switcher that goes in and deals with that. The boxcars, no, you don't want them. You want them to sit. But the cement loaders, I don't know if you need it on those tracks. Like, you might want to put box cars on another or something and have the loader go through. I don't know. I just don't know if the layout's perfect for these or not. So I'm gonna escape this for a minute. I'm gonna put, we are at 6:38 Eastern right now. I'm going to put the time back to, yeah, just before dawn, so that I can see everything. And once again, I'm actually gonna open it up, see, to make sure. This is where you can see if it, all of a sudden it's peering off to some other industry track. I didn't see a coal loader over there, so I assume it's part of the map. But let me just take a look at that too. Yeah, let me take a look at that. Where are we at? Are we, oh, okay, perfect. Ah, okay, perfect. So, whoa, hold on a second here. I see the track that goes that way. That's the cement, but then there's a coal unloader. Okay, so let's take a look at this here. I've never really taken a really good look at this, apparently. I thought it was, oh, I see. It's not to scale. Gotcha. So we got the two different loaders there. Perfect. Now, what you can do in the mat in this, actually, you can create your create dual industries so that the proper cars go there. But that's what you want. You want. I don't think we have a cement. Number one, I don't think we can have a unit train set up, but. I don't think it's there, so
It's almost, yeah, it's about 6:40 Eastern right now. I'm just going to hold this here for a moment and we'll keep on going. I don't know how far we are in the industries list, to be honest. Yeah, not too bad actually. It's getting there, but we're not going to probably do it all tonight, so I'm not going to worry about that. I'll take a look at the quarry here for a minute. We'll transport over to that. I want to see that for a minute though, before I deal with this. Once again, the quarry's is way too high at 20 capacity. It should be at 1. And I'm not too sure what the tracks are set up for it. There's a lot. So if there's a lot there, then that probably means, and because this is a shuttle, it doesn't matter. You don't need to have it at 72. So if people want to run a train and they're bored, there we go. And it's just a rock shuttle, so go at it. Have fun. You know, you just bring it back and forth, and there's your open hopper, which turns you back into loads, which in return should turn it back to empties at the other side, I think. Once again, I don't even have to look at this, but I can bring that down. And then I go over to transport to that industry. And sure enough, it is there. I don't know what all those extra. You know, there's all kinds of extra tracks. I guess they're just for, you know, whatever. Okay, Chem Tools next. We got that set up at least, and now the CMX Q and R will be limited on the mixed trains. If they do pop up, who's to say? I mean, I know you're going to get an odd thing of rock that's going to come in once in a while. They're also coming in the open hopper. I don't like that. Isn't this a rock quarry, not a, why are they coming in open hoppers? Aren't they ballast? I mean, I don't know, but maybe I'm behind, I thought they would be on ballast, not, they're rocks. They're not coal. Didn't we? Yeah, we had an industry earlier that did it, didn't we? Didn't I see it earlier? Vulcan or something? Let me see this here. We got ballast hoppers that are going to Savage, apparently. Which is kind of odd, but you know, hey, whatever. I think that's wrong. I mean, I'm okay with it. I'm not going to worry about it right now because it's really not an interactive industry, but there shouldn't be coal cars for the rock thing. At least I don't think there should. Well, I'll ask them about it if they want to change it or whatever, and I'll mention it in the suggestions. But anyways, I will be back in a few minutes.
anyways, coming back here now.
So we got a lot of good changes starting. I know alphabetically we're only on C, but that isn't going to be a big deal. That was just my empty. And no, it's not beer. It's Coke Zero, just in case you're wondering. Chem Tool. I think that's going to be fine. I'm going to transport to that industry. One thing I will mention, I gotta talk to. I had to find out through what LOQ 53 is. I thought LOQ 53 was the flyer. Apparently, it may or may not be. I don't know. I don't remember getting a response in the forums. Maybe I missed it, but it kind of just, I asked about it and then I don't remember seeing a response. So maybe I missed it, but I don't know. But basically, we got a symbol of Mojave and it's not doing anything. Last time I checked, anyways. So let me transport here, see what this is. This should be fine. Chem Tool. Yeah. Damn, I've been screwing up here. I gotta check this out for a minute. I keep forgetting to make sure everything's okay. So Chem Tool's okay, I think. North Platte, yep. So that's good. See, we got a Bakersfield again. Another tank car. So I'll change that. Let me transport that. Where is that anyways? I don't even know exactly where that is. Looks cool. Okay. So the times are fine for those. Those aren't industrial switchers. They're done by the crew. I think that's Victorville turn or whatever. So gotta check something again. Yep. Whoops. Where the hell did I can't even remember the name of the industry it is. Oh, not Edwards. I can't remember what. I can't remember the name of the industry. Church and Dwight, C&D. Do I even have that on my list? Oh, really? Did I miss it? Oh, it's up here. Okay, fine. It wasn't alphabetical. Okay. So, Bakersfield. Oh, it's going to be for both of these, so. If they have enough out of it, I don't bother changing it, but the others, why not? I don't know what this COF thing is. So I changed the Bakersfield Fresnel for now. Yep. I know why empty refrigerator cars are going to Bakersfield. I get it. They're going to be used for the trade. The problem is you got all this demand coming in. It would be nice, actually. I don't know if it can do it.
It'd be nice if it actually was able to randomly select some of those cars and just say, you're in an empty yard. The problem is the way the industries are set up right now, it doesn't matter. As long as it's a car type that's specific to that, it's going to go to it and it's going to say, okay. And the way you just can't do it, at least not the way the system is set up. It's not capable of doing it. I would love to see that, as opposed to, because what you're getting is you're getting that's the classic example of confiscation. You send your refrigerator cars back to Bakersfield where they're in demand, as opposed to shipping a bunch of empties into Manifest coming from everywhere outside the region. So I get it. I really do. But in our case here, the closest thing we can do, and this will actually help the Bakersfield train, is to send it to Fresno. Because then at least we're able to get it to number one, we're building up the back bar. We're giving BNSF Bakersfield a little bit more to do, besides, the limited locals they have. So they're able to do something. So I figure, why not? So if I transport to the industry, am I at the industry? No, I don't think I'm there, am I? Transport. Whereabouts that is. Oh yeah, that looks familiar, somewhat. Oh, it's by mile 41. Okay. So yeah, send it off to there. Oh, I can do that. Okay. So that's why I'll put those in there. At least then we know, like, okay, then we know, right? CGL. Do we really have a CGL? Ah, crap. I hate that when that happens. I don't know how to get out of that screen. I don't know how I get into it. Do I hit it again? Can I? No, of course not. Okay, fine. Go away. Oh, man. I just saved that stupid thing. I'll deal with it later. Ah, crap. I didn't want to do that either. Okay, go back into this. I don't know why I don't just put it in the sheets, to be quite honest. Oh, I know why. Because it was a file that was saved really originally on the computer and I never converted it. So that's why. So yeah, I'll deal with that. Who cares about what the sheet says? I'm just gonna start setting those to Fresno. And I'll try to remember to explain that. But I'm not going to type it in for every one of them. We'll deal with it. Kanagra. Conglass. That's kind of cool. I got stuff going to GATX. I kind of like that. That's a neat one. So. Ooh, I got my flashlight on. When did I put that on? Oh, excuse me. Nice. I like that. We still have industries to add too. Like out in okay, so Consolidated Grain. I think everything looks good there. Funky. Covered hoppers. Yeah, I just realized that it was the covered hoppers was taking any covered hopper for grain? Or was it? I'm not sure about that. I just realized that. I don't know why. Weird. But the grain train, oh yeah, the grain trains do it differently though, because the grain trains that set up in the AI system will take it as a covered hopper, but consolidated grain loads them up, sends them off to UP, either in covered hoppers or boxcars, or UP, what the, never mind. Yeah, it's UP. There, I'm losing it. I don't know. I was thinking CP for a second. Don't ask me. Whoa. Oh, is this Edison? Oh, crap, it is. That place don't take crap anymore. I got it down to two cars, at least. I think they're closed, but anyways, whatever. I'm not going to argue with it. If it's there, fine. Cortec transport. El Paso. I don't know where that is. I don't care. D&W. So yeah, I'm gonna do this for about an hour more. There we go with Bakersfield again. D&W. Taking gondola loads. Well, at least it's got something now. I like, what the heck? Where are these things supposed to be going? I'll have to go into that sheet later on and just find all the Bakersfield and say, okay, well, that's what it meant to be. It was supposed to be that. Then I'll make sure that everything's set up for. Ooh, wow. That only takes one car, huh? Is that the little roadie ramp thingy there, or is that just, oh, that's the end of the track. Interesting. I like that one. That's really cool. I like these industries that only pop up one every now and then. You get the odd one, and here it is, and boom. I think that's, you know, I gotta get off the couch and take a look at that for a minute.
Excuse me. Okay, it is WCL space RV.
If it's gonna be WCL comma RV, then it'd be kind of. So where's Fort Worth supposed to go? We don't have a train that goes to Fort Worth, do we? What the hell? Center beam flat. That goes to Fort Worth? Really? Which will be kind of cool, because once we have some of these areas, then we can figure out. I'm not gonna go and validate all of these, and then once I will make, I'll mention that, like Fort Worth, Texas, that can go onto another train, and then what I'll do is I'll pop in Fort Worth into the hump configuration to make sure that main lines that have that, because what'll happen is a lot of that will go into the slough track. It won't know what to do with it. Actually, it'll come back, yeah, it'll come back from some of the industries, and then it'll, you know, do whatever. I haven't got any local industries set up just yet. That's something we'll figure out. Oops. Oh, that was a text.
Who's texting me? One new message. Oh, okay.
Pardon me for a minute. Just gonna text my buddy. I don't have too many friends, believe it or not, so. Let me see. I was just thinking about him the other day. Text back, but yeah, so I'm not sure what did I transport to this. Sorry, is this it? This must be it, right? Oh, yeah, whatever. So it's Dixieland lumber center beams, empty center beams. Really, they should be going back. Never mind, Fort Worth. They should be. Why aren't they going to Fort Worth? How about VAW? About that. Personally, I think they should be going to Vancouver, Washington instead of Fort Worth, but we'll leave Fort Worth for now. They should get the stuff for the Pacific Northwest stuff, right? At least that's my thought. Whatever. Oh God, Edwards Air. Oh my God, no. 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 Alright, so we got Edwards Air Force Base. I understand, I get it, it once was an industry long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, but, wow, why has it got that whole freaking string of, doesn't need that much, it should all be in there, but anyways, okay, so what I'll do is I see, and then you got Chicago. We don't have trains going to Chicago, especially not boxcars. But anyways, so guess what? It does exist. The odd thing is going to come in, but instead of 20. I'm putting it down to 1 because I know this industry is not served any longer. There's a bunch of other ones up there too that I really haven't looked into. I know this one is not served. I would rather the Boron local only go out there at an odd time because that's the way we've always done it. So that's my call on it. So, you know, people want to start switching stuff. It is even that one at Edison, like two, that grain thing. I don't know. Let's see, Barlac cases, Barkay, North Platte, that's an interesting one. Fitzgerald Fabrication. And a lot of these I haven't really researched too much, so I don't know too much about those. Frito-Lay, here we go. Fresno, Debob, North Platte, RV, Giotis, Ra. See how it's all coming UP, so why would BNSF send anything? Well, they could send loads, but there's a lot of demand for there. Yeah, I was gonna say Frito-Lay's got the covered hoppers and they got the tanks. Very nice. They did a good job of that. Glad to see that. Okay. Yeah, I'm good with that. Geo drilling. Let's search using the closest truck. That's a neat one. So you can go through all the industry. That's kind of cool, actually, you know, now that I think about that. Ooh, what's that? Where are we here? Oh! Okay, that's cool. So this is geo drilling fluid, huh? Looks like it takes a lot. Oh yeah, it wants to put stuff to Bakersfield again. Empty stuff to Bakersfield. No. No. Fresno. It's got stuff going to Houston. Yeah, we can change though, and like I said, we can add those. Like, if once the trains, if we start finding stuff is popping up in Barstow and they're not the hump's not taking it, then we change it around. So we'll be fine with that. I'll take that on a an ad hoc basis as they come along. I'm not worried about changing those. If they're going to Houston, yeah, why not? Let's have a tag for Houston. I got no problem with that. Technically, we could block it for it, but we don't. I don't know if we need to. I don't know. I don't want to make more work, put it that way. Okay, so Goodyear tire. Let's back up needles if I remember seeing my stuff. And, okay, cool. I like that. One car. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Because that's all, that sounds perfect for those industries. These are these little oddball things. Why has Greenstone got so much? I don't buy that. Wow. Does it really have that? Huh? It's not even set up for the industry. It's set up to the fence. Wait a minute. Okay. First of all, why is it set up outside the fence? I mean, I understand there's a fence here, but isn't that supposed to be there? Am I right? Am I missing something here? You know something? Let me just try some of these features here. Let me just try some of this feature. So we've got Greenstone Solutions, right? I wanna try something. Search using the closest track. What does that do? I haven't really discovered that. So search using the. Okay. Is there another industry in the area? There's one right here. Uh-oh. Not good. Well, that's an industry too. Okay, watch this. Ooh, that's neat. Is that Suncoast, huh? Okay. So we found out we found out though the Greenstone screwed up. Not literally, but so why did I transfer? It's right there, you goof. Okay, so Greenstone, I'm going to change this because that's I don't like that spot. Yeah, we'll flatter him and put the thing. It should be in the fence. To me, I mean, let's put it inside the fence of the industry instead of having it. Doesn't that make sense to you? Because there's all the bay doors, and they're not way down there. So at least we'll add it. I don't know. To me, that makes sense. I know we can have it here too, but let me edit the tracks. Yeah, see? That should be in there. We'll save that. All right. Anyway, the industry, everything else, San Diego, Stockton. Yeah, I'm cool with that. Nine cars, jeez. Is that a real industry? Probably, well, Greenstone Industries, duh, but Bar Pass, Bar Phoenix. We really don't have a Phoenix train, I don't think. But I'm okay for it for now. Oh, Gamera Farms. Ooh, yes. Boxcar, covered hopper. Oh, ooh, yeah. That's even more. More than I thought. Okay. Wait a minute. So what's this industry? Chop liver? Okay. What's this? I'm confused. I know we haven't switched out here, but or we have actually. We started switching out here, so oh, it's not woo. Isn't that interesting? Okay, so that means okay, why isn't that working now? How come that's not working all of a sudden? It was working before. Like, is it upset or something? That worked great before. It just doesn't like it there for some reason. Okay, why? Like, is there another industry? Yeah, I gotta check the maps now. What the heck that's supposed to be like that for? I mean, I get that there's a track there, and theoretically there could be more stuff. There's not supposed to be that much stuff there anyways, is there? I didn't think there was. Alright, so I guess I gotta open up another, you know what? So this is the Mojave sub. We're gonna go back up and find out what's going on with this industry here. Oop, we don't wanna go that far. Well, Gamera is supposed to be GIU. I think that's what it is, but we don't have. There's three tracks, really? Is there really? Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hold on. Hold on a second here. Now I'm. Oh, it's those three tracks. I gotcha. So that means we. For some reason, it wasn't added. I want to double check this just to make sure. I got a 720. Ooh. No, JR Simplat is 726, which makes sense because that's not really to scale. GIU, which is. This is calling a GUI. Yeah. Well, which one are we using here? I say we use GIU, and then we're gonna change this. I'm gonna change that to GIU. I'm gonna go into there. I'm gonna edit the tracks, and then I'm gonna add this one as well. I don't know if I have to edit that whole area there. I'm going to say no on the curve. Save that. Edit the industry, and then we are fine. Everything else is fine. Halliburton. Oh, I didn't check. Everything else looks fine. I did check that. Okay. Halliburton will transport there. Six cars of tanks to empty out. That's good. See, I'm just making sure it makes sense, right? You want it to make sense. You want them to go back. Yeah, that makes sense. All right. Like I said, if it's not spotted, then I don't know. We should put little markers on, but the problem is they're easy to delete, and I don't want to risk doing that. I'd rather have a comprehensive. I wonder if you can do that, like when we're into an area, like a spotting, like a picture. Because you get this area right here, right? And then you go into edit tracks. So you know by looking at that, you can crop that and say, okay, well there's your industry, right? Save. Edit the industry. Well, as soon as I take it out, it's gonna, the screen's going to disappear. So, but you know, it's something. So that's Halliburton. Hesperia Wholesale Lumber. Makes sense. I don't know what this one is. Is there anything in this other track? Does it really matter? Six. There's six tracks there. But then, see, then there's room for excess. Do I have to go to needles? Oh, jeez. I had that for a minute, too. And then it disappeared. It might be another track, I don't know. Makes sense, you get closest to the thing. I don't want needles, you goof. Why did I say that? Okay, HWL. That was weird that I found that one that was just kind of odd. Oh, we want to go to Hesperia. Hesperia, when you're near. Oh, that's Hysteria. Sorry. No, that's Hesperia right there. Oh, there it is. Okay. Ah, so it is saying it's just that. Oh, that's Omia, I guess. Omia. I guess that's Omia. Oh, I see. They're using different industries for various whatever. Okay. Cool. I'm good with that. Everything else looks good there. Wow, six cars though, that's a lot. Hondo, Fresno, whatever the heck that other one is. Transport. Ooh. Acid tank cars and... Dang, where are we? Hondo sounds familiar too. Yeah, whatever. It seems to load a lot more, but anyways, okay, that's fine. Industrial pipe and steel. Says it takes three, whatever. Industrial, oh man, I'm getting lazy and I'm forgetting to check out the various Interstate, okay, perfect. What am I around? BNSF Bakersfield? I think I am. Looks familiar. Well, we're getting a lot more industries in this area. I'm okay for that, just to make it interesting, but... whoa. Bar Watt, Bar Lack, Bar San Diego, JC. Oh. That's a lot. A lot of boxcars. Oh, that's JG Bowles. Oh, the tomato place. That's right. Cool. That's out on the current supply. I knew it sounded familiar. Simplot. Yeah. Looks good. So a lot of these industries, like the main ones there. Oh yeah, Simplot's that one, yeah. Got that one, that's for sure. Now of course we have a lot of potash cars that we used to put in there, but we don't have a potash ability at the moment by the looks of it. Jastro. This is interesting, because it's got this unit train. But it's calling 15. I don't understand this. It just, what does it do? It just decides to randomly send out a unit train once in a while? Oh, it's a unit train. No, see, it's a unit train that goes from Los Angeles to Bakersfield. I don't get this train. I really don't. I don't know what it's supposed to be doing. Holy crap. Like, and the demand on it too, it's like 15. As far as I know, in our era, that's dead. I think that's there's a lot of stuff that's actually looked pretty dead to me. But I'll keep it in there, whatever. We'll figure that out later, and somebody can complain about it or tell me it's wrong or whatever. We don't have a unit train that goes out there, so I'm not worried about it. Is that Johnson Farms? All right, perfect. Kaiser Steel. Ooh. That's going to be an interesting one. Now, this I did not put in. What is it set up for? Ooh. Okay. Well, that's kind of cool. What's that? Is that like a bridge? Like a highway or something that's supposed to be there? Kind of looks that way, doesn't it? Okay, what's that? So this is off at Kaiser Yard here. Now I gotta get back to Needles again. Dang it. Or do I? No, Cajon, you doofus. Okay. Now, of course, they call it California Steel Industries. I'll see if he wants to change it, but I'm not gonna touch it. He's got it as Kaiser right now. To go in line with everything else, it should match these just so people know, but you know, I'll just go with it for now. So that's that sucker right there. California Steel Industries. What kind of car is it taking, anyways? Is it the it's going to Pittsburgh. It's taking gondolas, which could be anything. That's the problem with those cars too, is they'll end up being anything. Only 36 hours, which, you know, it's fine. If it goes to the yard or whatever, and I don't know. I don't know too much more about that than anybody. Oh, Chimera. Kansas City, Fresno, Kansas City pass. Yeah, we're good there. Oh, yeah. Wow. That looks like it's supposed to be on a line going somewhere that it's kind of is, but isn't, or what the heck is that? Okay, I'm getting confused here. We got a line here that's like upside down in the middle of something or other. Where are we? Oh, now I know. I wasn't sure where we were. I was like, oh crap, we're in Lone Pine. So that's really going to be all about Chimera. Wow. Okay. Cool. Yippity-yay. Whatever. That's served. See, that's served by LOP 53. So that's that. There's that train again. So Lone Pine, I guess that's a local out of. So 53 is a local that runs out of Mojave then. Okay. I thought that was the Mojave Flyer, but I guess not. Kern Meat. Oh, I didn't check. Everything else is fine with that. That's cool. I'm all right with that. We were the idea that we toyed was we have a Trona coal train, but then we didn't have a way of getting the empties out because we just basically ran the train to the end of the track and said bye-bye, and that was it. So Because we don't have a spawn available, we can't get that train to come back in or out. We were going to use this yard, but I don't think there's enough there anyways, and it would be a pain in the... I'd rather see it used as an industry. I'm all for that. So, Kern Meat. We're actually getting through a lot of this. This is going to be... I'm really happy about this. And, you know, like I was down earlier today. Once you get into things, suddenly everything else doesn't matter, so... It's really cool. So yeah, there's only 5 cars there. That's fine. That has to be like double switch to get in there. But oh, Kern Oil. Whoa, that's a lot of crap. Transport to that. Let's see what we got. That. Oh no. Is it really this thing here? Oh, this ain't good. This ain't good. Not if we want... so this is gonna be... I don't like that at all. The only way I like that... well, there is one way. There's actually one. No, see, that's supposed to be SJVR. That's not supposed to be BNSF. I'm against that. That's the SJVR line. That's not supposed to be part of Edison. I'd be okay if Kern Oil was part of the Magadan thing, but man, I don't like that at all. So right now we don't have a Magadan in there, but I'm going to take a look once I transport into there, see about setting something up, then we'll see. But anyways, what we got? Perpetual supply. Whoa. Is that like a real industry that's lit up, or that's so dang bright I can't even see? Oh, there it is. So I see it along the curve there, but what the hell? Oh yeah, there's little red dots in there. It's just so bright you can't see it. My future is so bright I need shades. Oh, Kern Steel. There we go. Fresno, North Kansas City. Perfect. Well, at least we're getting rid of the stupid tags. When I call stupid tags, I mean the ones that... Oh, that's that one over there. Okay. I know where that is. Yep. Nice. Nice. Kern Tractor Supply. Oh, yeah, this is around Funky. There's that Chicago again. And Fort Worth. Whatever. King Back Potato. Here we go. Okay, here's the thing, folks. Yeah. All right, here's the thing about this industry, at least in our era. That track there is buildings. They use that. I don't know what to suggest on this one. I mean, I know it's there. I know it's a pain in the rear, but... That's just not how the industry works anymore, or has worked even up to the last 6 years ago. So I don't know. I mean, it's there. Why is it only doing... Is loading 7? Is loading acid tank cars? Really? Okay. Kingback Potato loads acid tank cars, apparently. Alright, fine. Whatever. Kirschman Transport. Sure. Where are we? Ooh. Oh, that's one of the... Never mind.
Oh, I wanted to see that for a minute. Go back here for a minute. King pack. Yeah, that's all. Curdent. Sun's coming up because everything's turned orange. I love that though. I love that, it's just you can't see the sun. Oh, it's so neat. I love the effect. Like, look at everything. You can't see the sun, it's through the fog somewhere. I love it. I love the, I just love the effect. You know. Be nice to see a, like a nice orange sun just blazing over here. Oh yeah, it'd be so cool. Cause you can have it in the fog, right? Cause with the fog, could actually play around with it so that it's not just your normal looking sun. Because the reason why it goes red is distortion in the atmosphere. It's why you always see the redness. I think that's all. I wasn't good at science, but you know, as far as I know, that's what that, you know, red sky night sailors did, red sky in the morning, whatever, however that goes, sailors take warning, blah blah blah. Oh, there we go. Mars pedicure. Boxcars and covered hoppers. Okay, cool. Bakersfield, no. So let me change that. I understand why they're going there. We're just not sending them to Bakersfield. They can go to Fresno. Then they can disappear and come back or whatever. I don't care. Come back on something else. I don't want them. Transport. Woo! The big industry, big spur, but only like four tracks or whatever, or four car demand, which is fine. I'm all for that, especially stuff I don't know anything about. Mitsubishi, well, that's neat. Wow, we finally got some stuff going to Vancouver. I haven't seen any yet. We'll figure out the logistics later on. I'm not too worried about it right now. Well, what the heck is this? Oh yeah. So it's in this little area that has a runaround thingy, majiggy. Where is it supposed to? Really? Oh, is this one of those goofy ones that are over there that are? Oh yeah, never mind. I'm not even gonna worry about it. It takes cars. Monolith. Ooh. Okay. Monolith's an interesting one. It does take open hoppers, accordingly, 15. Jeez. Wow, I gotta see this for a minute. Let me see what it looks like here. Ooh, boy. So that's being specific where, not really being specific where the stuff's coming from or coming out of or whatever. Just by industries of some sort. And if they don't spot them right, then what do we got here? For like 48, 51 potential cars. Oh yeah, there's the coal thingamajig right there. It's served by LOQ53 again, so I guess that is a... Okay, so we got some empty acid.
See, it's interesting. Some of these send acid, some of them take them out. So then, I'm thinking to myself, okay, so this is going to Phoenix. Fresno, another Phoenix. I want to say, when is the open hopper at? 15? Yeah. We'll deal. We'll assume that there's not an industry switcher in there and that we switch it and we make it all pretty and that's all they need to know about that. Sounds good. We'll get to the rest. So, oh, Nebo Logistics. I don't even want to look at that. Oh, geez. Do we really? There were a lot of questions I had last week, and I didn't get any answers to them. Holy, what the? So we got something there. Something there. Oh, something over there, and hell, we got stuff everywhere. I like the fact that we're doing something with them, but I don't know. There's like 35 cars going to Nebo. I honestly like the fact that we're doing something with it, and maybe here's the maybe part. I'll say this much. The maybe part to me is that yes, it potentially gives something for a Yermo switcher to do. So if that's the purpose, then okay. The problem I have with it is that industry isn't served anymore. As beautiful and big and everything else that it is, it does not get served. The grain one does. I know that. We haven't figured out who the hell's in control of it yet. I don't know if Wes Colton is going to take control of that because it's UP, and then I have to work with them, or because now we're trying to deal with jurisdictions. I got a whole whack that I have to deal with Sam. I shouldn't say I'm not saying that I'm the one that has to deal with everything. What I'm saying is I still have to deal with Boron, Cadiz, which isn't fully set up yet because I still have to deal with the interchange. There's another industry in Cadiz that isn't set up yet, and then Boron, which I've started here, but I got to go back into the forums and see where everybody's at. Actually, let me do that while I'm actually here. So this place takes a bunch of loads and this empties them and sends them back to places. Okay, I'm cool with that. None of them go to Yermo. I gotta watch out for that too, because if a bunch go to Yermo for some stupid reason, then they're just gonna sit there forever. Let me turn the clock back an hour. If I can time. No. Anyways. Woo! I got lights. Lights are good. Flashing light on the tower. Turn the lights on. Alright. Cool. Star's back out. What am I doing? Yeah, I wanted to check. Okay, that's what I wanted to do. Never mind. Wanted to check the forum for a minute just to see where everybody's at. I want to do a search on that because I know I put a post up about this and I didn't get a response. I don't think. I probably won't be on too much in advance of this session. Okay. Okay, so I'm just letting him know I'm still going through industries at this point. So nothing will be ready until tomorrow sometime. I'll also start asking more questions in regards to what we want to do. The good thing is I'm alphabetically up to Nebo right now. I actually came on here to see if anyone responded to my inquiries over in the various yard offices. I'll put a smiley sign. Because I don't know. I don't think I got responses. Or did I post them? I thought I posted them last week. I could be wrong. Let me see. San Bernardino, new member. Yep. To become a new member. CYO Industrial Post. Barstow Trim Hostling. I don't think it would be in there. Session tonight. No. A-Line. Nope. Smiley Server. No. Sunday. No. No. California server was down. UP West Colton new registry. I don't know if I put it in there, but I'll check it anyways. I thought I responded to that because I hadn't looked at it. It really looked pretty cool too, what he had set up for the various multi-monitor setup. Show off. Oh, no, actually, I thought Ski did that. I'm sorry, it's not Anya. Ski was posting pictures of his multi-monitor setup. I'm like, you. Oh, show off to me. Bugger. He's got this cool truck, too. I got this little red Fiat. Yeah, it's okay, but man, his truck's nice. He's got a nice one. Attempted fail to log into A-Line. But yeah, I saw his multi-monitor. I would love to dispatch that way. Now, mind you, I got this huge, nice, big screen TV that I barely watch anything on TV. I just use it for a glorified computer monitor. I watch wrestling on it though with my son, so. That part's cool. And I have the surround sound and everything in here, too. But, you know. San Bernardino yard board. Is that where I post it? California operations. I don't think. I don't think I would have put that in there. Oh, okay. No. Yeah, we're going back to 3 days ago now. I thought I posted something. I can't find it. So now that's like 2 days ago. Now we're humps in general. Okay, see, I posted up the. Okay, so it wasn't. I'll have to. I'll see if Tony. Got this message. What did I say about? I know it's a long post. I get it. I post long things, but I knew there was a post in there that I want to find out what's going on. But I don't know. Live Steam instead of live stream. I guess that was the only post I got, but here. See, I didn't get any updated changes. This was 3 days ago, so I'm going to assume everything's fine and dandy. Where are we at? We're at 45 minutes after. I don't think we're gonna have too much. I don't even know how much people we have available for tonight at this point, but that's okay. I'm having fun with this anyways. Let me go back to the industries. So yeah, we got Nebo. I'll post about that if I can remember. Newberry. Why is it taking open hoppers? It's ballast. Oh man. What the hell? You mean to tell me it's loading up coal? What is this PMT? Is that a name of an industry or something? What is that? Bakersfield PMT. Paramount? Oh. Well, that's interesting. See, you have an example of actually. So Paramount Petroleum has taken an open hopper. I gotta see something for a minute here. I haven't changed them yet, but I'm gonna have to start That's neat how Nebo just, there we go, Newberry Ballast Pit. Okay. Okay, so that goes, okay, Nebo goes there. So we do have cars that are staying on BNSF but transferring over to, not Nebo. They're actually transferring over to a to Paramount Petroleum. So what that's doing for me, okay, I see that almost as a shuttle again. And if that's all it is, you see the hope, and you got the ballast pit, right? The only place it's going, according to that, is it's loading ballast for Paramount Petroleum. Wow. Almost looks to me like there's a lot of experiment that was going on, but. Interesting. So Paramount Petroleum is there. So I gotta try to remember this one here. Me take a look at this too, just to see. Oof. See, this is where it could really get interesting to have some of these trains with the ballast cars, but for some reason that's loading it up like it's coal. And this is and this is what they, to me, should know about, because what that's doing is you're adding more and more cars into the mix. And there's no demand structure. You either put it to the industry and it goes, and if all it's doing is going back and forth like a shuttle, you got to bring this down to at least one. And I just have a hard time picturing that as a shuttle. But I don't know. And I'm sure this is, don't quote me on this guy, and I know there's BNSF employees that help advise Run8 studios. I don't know if that's legitimate. Or if that's just experimental. It's only the Newberry Ballast Pit. I mean, you know, it is what it is. I don't know. We never had Newberry set up for some reason. We didn't get around to it when the rock ballast cars came out. But this isn't even using rock ballast. It's using coal cars. It's using the open hoppers. So I don't know. I don't know. I don't know what to say about that. Let's see, Nickler Chemical. I mean, I haven't seen that was the first one that kind of got my attention. I'm like, what? Is that really like that? No, it can't be. See, this guy's G. Do we have a GATX set up? I don't remember even seeing that. We don't. Well, that's interesting. We got stuff going to GATX. It's not coming out. Oh boy. Which isn't as long as as long as the demand's not too bad, then it can come back out and say, okay, well, the tank car is going to repairs, and then it's going someplace. I don't know what that means. It's an empty car going for repairs, like. Because I know they're not GATX, as far as I know, it's just car repair. I don't think it's anything else. I don't think they're going to need empty to fill up tanks at GATX. It doesn't make sense. So yeah, I don't know. GATX might be one of these industries you got to add to where you're just basically popping up a bunch of. You put the hours up like way huge. Of course, you can't. You can only go up to 7 days with this, but then that's fine. And then you send it away someplace, and away it goes. I don't know. Oh, North American. Wait a minute. Let me go back to Nicolor for a minute. Do we have Nicolor? Where do we go here? Transport. Oh yeah, I like those industries. Those industries are cool. So that's done by 53 as well, huh? Wow. North American, but nah. I already see it. North American only takes three cars, and where you have Edwards that are going goofy. Like, really? Okay, so I'm gonna take that, and I'm gonna take that, and I'm gonna just put a bell. I'm not even gonna bother. San Bernardino, I'm getting that out of there as well. Two bay covered hoppers. They're taking the two bays? Really? Okay. If you say so. I ain't gonna argue. They only want three cars, huh? Funky. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I remember that one. Eight cars for Omia. Ooh. It's all going to Bell. Alrighty. So we're Pactiv now. Ooh. More GATX. I actually like. See, the tank. I like that, actually. You get empties that are going off to there once in a while, which is kind of cool. Pactiv. But we have to set up GATX as an industry, or else it's going to get interesting. Okay, that works good for me. Paramount Petroleum. No, it's not going to Bakersfield. Are you kidding me? So I'm gonna send that off to Fresno. I don't know how else. Like, sending it to BK does nothing because it involves tagging, and we're trying to get away from that. So I just don't see it. Oh yeah, there's your open hopper to Newberry thing. This is where we used to use the flammable ones, and then we had different types that were coming in, and it was kind of cool actually. Okay. So it's Paramount, PPG Aerospace. I just don't know what everything means as of yet. Aggressive rail. That's oh yeah, that's the one by Lone Pine, I think. I think that's on Lone Pine. Yeah, it looks like it's looks like it's oh yeah, that's Mojave. Okay, good. That's cool. I like how it does that. That's really cool. Progressive Farms, Fresno, whatever, blah blah blah. Transport. Okay, very good. Lots of stuff going there. Covered hoppers and refrigerator cars. All right. Loads going out. Empty. Yep. Rio X. Four cars. That's it. Oh, we're bigger than that. Okay, whatever. I'm not gonna complain. We've had 10 cars in there, but that's okay. Ooh, Riverside Cement. Ah, that we're tired. This is okay. This is one, another one. It's demanding. Oh, okay. Hold on a second here. I haven't set Riverside up yet. It's calling for 8 cars of open hoppers, but we already got a unit train coming in. So what I will do for now, and I haven't set it up yet. I'm looking at everything else here just to make sure. Don't like this Bakersfield thing. Forget that. As long as it's got some places to go, I'm not worried about forcing it to Fresno. So it's got the two bay covered hoppers. We have, yeah, I see it calling to empty for open hoppers to Belleville or Bell or whatever the hell it's called. Oh, I forget how that one is set up, but there's no way you're gonna have it. It's gonna call a bunch of coal cars at that point. Now, I know we have a river cement. We have a switcher that goes in there that actually will deal with it. I just don't see it being that active. So it's always going to be in the yard. We just don't have it set up for that industry yet. So, yeah, open hoppers, it's going to call a bunch and then it's going to send them to Bell. I'm not too sure about that one. But let's just bring that back down because it's already coming in on the Oral Grand train. I forget where it's coming off of, ESS or Grand, I can't remember. But we'll leave it. I'm going to put that there for a minute as Bell. Let me just go back to Simex for a minute. No, that's not the one. That's the quarry. One and one, yeah. Yeah, that's what I want. See, they got it going. Like they're going someplace. So, I'm going to change that to empty unit. And hopefully people understand what that means. Is it RVS? Or no, it's RSV. So what I'm doing is I'm setting it up to go to Riverside, back to Riverside Cement, so that wait a minute, hang on a second. So I'm calling that RSV unit outbound for now. I forget where it's going, but we want those to go back onto the unit train, and I think that's going to be pretty clear. So when I go to here, Riverside Cement Plant, I'm not bringing it to Bell. I'm also bringing that down. So I'm calling it unit outbound because it's at Riverside Cement. So when I transport over to here, I'll show you what I mean. So what we got in the yard here. We've got over here. This is the cement. Those are the cement loaders right there. And then we've got the track over here where we have the loader, which is right there. So there's a lot there. We have all these Oral Grand cars coming in. The cement's not as important. It goes in, you know, it comes in on the trains. It's not going to be loaded and emptied as much or as quickly as that's going to be. That's what that's all about. That's why I dropped that. I don't have the industry switching set up there yet. We'll figure that out. Here we go to some of the more important ones. So, San Bernardino Auto. We want to reduce that. Let me see here. Hang on a second here. It's only going to be able to do what it can do, put it that way. So, whatever cars are available, I don't think I want to do it at 1. How about we put it down to 24 hours? And then we're taking, we don't want, we do not want, these are all coming in on unit trains as far as I know. I'm just going to take a look to make sure of that, but I'm pretty sure they all come in on unit trains. We don't have them coming in on mixed. But let's take a look at the industry, see how it's set up. And it is set up perfectly to only those two tracks, which is perfect. But we bring down the capacity down to 1, so it's only coming in on the unit trains now. Chicago and Clovis, those are your, that's it. That's exactly what we want. So it doesn't matter about the capacity, they're going to come in blocks and they're just going to do what they're supposed to do. So that's perfect. Local freight symbol Y, San Bernardino 2. I got confused here. One got changed and then the other got messed up or something. I don't know what happened. Okay, here we go again. Now, intermodals don't matter, but the hour capacity does. So I'm gonna go over here. The actual train that's being used is we had SBD and then it got changed or something got changed and then I don't know what happened, but so we're looking into our yard here. So we're looking at 222, which is currently set at Kansas City. I'm looking at the numbers here. Piggy flats, well car, 72s. So what I'm gonna do, I'll set it here for a minute. So you can just go like this, watch, see. What the hell is that noise? Strange shit. Okay, see that last track? All to West Peak, Chicago. See they all come into over here, right? The hell? Somebody got a. Sounds like somebody's got a pile driver somewhere in here. What I'm gonna do is, and I was talking about doing this before, was instead of loading up a new tag, and I don't know what to call it or where it's going, but we do have bare table trains that head out. So let me just double check here. First of all, let me bring these down. We don't want 72. Definitely down to 20. Holy crap. I have no idea what that noise is. I never know what anything's going on in here anymore. The capacities, I don't think they matter. I haven't seen any intermodal trains come in on mix, so it really doesn't matter. It's just going to come in with the units. So it'll be as simple as that. Can I just do that and make it easier? Yeah, I figured I could. Can I try a zero? Wouldn't that be sweet if it did? It won't allow it though, huh? It can't handle it. You can't handle the truth. Yeah. Okay. Doggy wars or something. So I'm going to stop that right there. Now I'm going to go back down to 226. I have no idea what the noise is. I give up. So what I'll do is I'm going to go over here back into the registry, and I'm going to take a look at San Bernardino. Or wait a minute, I gotta go back to the old Cajon tab, if we still have wherever it went to, Cajon sub. Okay, so I'm doing a search for BSBD, and there we go. So we got Bear Table trains for Pisgah on a Sunday. WSP 2 days a week. Fresno. And YUC. So YUC. Oh, okay. So you got the Pisgah ones. So Pisgah, WSP, PIS, WSP, I can make that twice. PIS, WSP twice, Fresno and Yuck, whatever that is. See if I can remember that. So I'm changing those to empty. I am going to go ahead and put 24, and I've already forgotten. I know Pisgah's one, Yuck. I can't remember the other ones. That's okay, I'll get it back to the other. Let me see if I can find it. WSP, oh yeah, Fresno, FRS. FRS, WSP, or no, I'll put WSP twice, then FRS. Get them all now. I think I got them all. So again, we'll put that as a 24-hour. So what that does is it allows it to send empty storage off to Pisgah as well. Eventually, what'll happen is if I add, I'm not too sure as far as the reasoning or why or when we would call the train, but eventually we will call a train to take those bare tables out and bring them in. If we were wanted to put extra demand or something, I don't know. That's just the way it is. I can't explain it any more than that. It's so that's basically turning them into bare tables. So if we're running out of room, there's not enough going out or whatever, I think I envision that track, instead of loading, would be doing that. So this is down to 24 hours. At least that'll get, I would imagine, hopefully that'll get enough. You don't want it to 12, I don't think. Although you could. It's possible, but yeah, anything's possible. So that's my ideas for that so far. So we got we're really at almost at the end now. I'll transport to that, just to see. I'm really close now to, towards the end. I got the flashlight on again because I probably typed or something. Yeah, that looks okay to me. Yeah, I like that the tank car is going to GATX. I really do. Some California components. All right. Specialty minerals. Okay, sure. Oh, that's that one at the end of the current. Is it? Oh, maybe not. I don't know. Whatever. I thought it was. Stock building store. Woo, wow. We don't have a Barstow train that goes to Fresno. That's a news flash. No, we don't have a Barstow train that goes to Fresno, I don't think. So I'll call that BAK. I might have missed it before and somewhere, but stock building, where the hell is that? Ooh, where are you? That must be one of the newer places. Yeah, I don't recognize that. That's neat. Funky. Okay. Suncoast. See, there's that Barstow Fresno again, right? We want that. There's no other train that goes that way, so I'll have to double check those, but that's, there is no Barstow Fresno train. Oh yeah, that's, I remember that. Okay. At Suncoast. Suncoast at Seiko. Why is that called Bakersfield Phoenix? I don't like that. Why don't we just call it Phoenix? Why is it? Why does it have to be BNS at Bakersfield? I understand the reasoning behind it, but problem is that you get it to BAK and then all of a sudden it comes back, because we really don't have a Phoenix setup that I know of. Two bay covered hoppers, empty. Bakersfield Phoenix, no. Yeah, so I'm gonna transport to that just to take a look at it, but I don't see how that's going to do anything else other than that. No. Okay, Seiko. Yeah, I know where that. I remember that one. So I'm 10 minutes away from having to do West Colton, GATS, Phoenix, Bell. Everything else looks okay. Oh yeah, I remember this one. Maybe not. I know I've done it, I just can't remember offhand. Oh, it's Saltus, duh. I was like, yeah, I know that. I knew it sounded familiar. Tetra. Tricor. Oh yeah. 52 tanks going to, what is NCC? I don't know what that is. Nicor Chemical? Like, what the hell is that? Oh, man. That's MCC, Mitsubishi Cement, not ANN. I don't know what that is. What is NCC? I just don't know that. Well, somebody's gonna have to describe that one to me because I don't know what NCC is unless I'm missing something. I'm looking here just to see if I can see this real quick, but I've seen Mitsubishi Cement. That doesn't make any sense. Although there is some tank cars, but that ain't it. There's got to be something else there. I don't see it. I'll leave it in there. I don't know what it means, but whatever. There we go. Back to this again. Union 66 is going to Bakersfield. No, it's not. It's going to Fresno. It's going to go anywhere. It'll go there. I know what that one was. That was that goodbye letter. Union 66. Whatever. USA Services. Transport to that. Okay, sounds good. Vulcan, yeah, we took a look at that, and I think we were okay. We've got ballast hoppers, everything else looks, I think, fine. Oh yeah, I changed the one, that's right. W.A. Murphy. Sure. Westcote locomotive fuel. Oh yeah, there we go. Unloading. I like the high, the maximum. That's really cool. So that's cool. I'm fine with that. It's putting it. Where the hell is it putting it? West Colton locomotive fuel unloading facility is over there. Is it really? Okay. Well, that's cool. Whatever. And the sand facility. It's calling too much, though. I think it is, anyways. Know it takes a lot, but you know, maybe not. And they're not coming in the unit trains. We know that. Okay, so fine. Let's just use it. I think it's cool. I think it's neat. It's just it's a lot. Wintag. So I think we'll get through this with 5 minutes to go. There's still going to be more. I'm going to go through some more details and oh yeah, there's your Euro grain. So they're going to go into well cars for LB. Load them 16 at a time, 120 covered hoppers. It wants to take in at the same time, so that makes sense because it's a transload, so that totally makes sense. Which comes over here, and we'll figure that out at some other point. So that's good. Okay, I'm gonna end this for now. I don't know if I'm gonna go live stream or not. It depends what we're doing, but I'm going to. Definitely, I'm going to end the live stream here for now, and then I will come back if it's worthy, because I'm probably dispatching, and if it gets too boring, might be too busy, but we'll see. We'll let you know. Anyways, come back. We'll see you in a bit. If not, we'll talk to you later.